a presentation of the ACC Network, an exclusive production of Raycom Sports.
Last weekend in the ACC was Upset Saturday.
Owen Smith, there's the toss. Got the block. Touchdown, Georgia Tech. And he makes the catch. Way! What a grab! Let the season play out.
And while the Clemson Tigers' undefeated season was put on ice, the ACC divisional races have fans fired up. Today, we'll break down a pair of interdivisional rivalries as Virginia travels to Maryland in search of bowl eligibility. And North Carolina looks to snap a four-game losing streak versus rival NC State. Things are heating up on a great ACC Saturday, and it all starts right now on the McAllister's Deli ACC Blitz. Making more headlines than usual, Everett Withers starts a war of words with TOB that spread like wildfire. But today is not about performance in the classroom. On the field, both coaches seemingly apologize with a handshake. And how about this? We are playing double duty here, which means Coach Bowden has to do double the work. We're getting you ready for two great games here on the ACC Network. It is week 10 of the McAllister's Deli ACC Blitz. He's Tommy Bowden. I'm Danielle Trotta. Coach, what games are you looking forward to most today?
Oh, the one in Raleigh. I might say something about your hair, just get you fired up. Giovanni Bernard, Mike Glennon should be a great battle. And then Wake Forest, Notre Dame. You know, if Wake Forest can eliminate the turnovers, it'd be a great win for the ACC taking over Notre Dame tonight.
Coach, I have a lot of hairspray on, and the last thing NC State UNC needs is to add more fuel to this fire. I could go up in flames at any moment. NC State, Wake Forest, Maryland, and Miami, all the battlefields where our ACC Network reporters are standing by. Let's begin our game day reports in Raleigh with Scotty P.
The talk this week, Danielle, has centered around both the head coaches, Everett Withers and Tom O'Brien, both exchanging pleasantries, if you will, about each other's program. And it has really stirred up the fan base for both these teams. We talked to some of the players about it, and they said, hey, we love it. It's State. It's Carolina. It's rivalry week. What more do you want? We expect plenty of emotion at kickoff today here at Carter-Finley Stadium.
Coming up, the ACC Network features two games, one an interstate rivalry, with two of the best QBs squaring off in Bryn Renner and Mike Glennon. Can they pick up where T.J. Yates and Russell Wilson left off? We'll find out soon.
McAllister's Deli ACC Blitz is brought to you by John Deere and by McAllister's Deli.
We have two games on the ACC Network today, but one has been making major headlines since Wednesday. UNC interim coach Everett Withers, this week in practice earlier, suggested that perhaps academic standards higher in Chapel Hill than they are in Raleigh. NC State head coach Tom O'Brien fires back, suggesting that he looks at his recent graduation rate, among other things. Coach, were you surprised at all that TOB fired back?
Well, you kind of saw the superficial pleasantries during that handshake right there. But, yeah, I think Tom O'Brien right now, he's an experienced coach, but a little frustrated on how his season has gone, how the injuries have accumulated. I think he was venting frustrations. Everett Withers, inexperienced coach, loyal to North Carolina, wants the job, just verbalized it the wrong way. So it should be interesting makeup in this game.
It certainly gave us media members a whole lot to talk about this week, Coach, but the bottom line is how it affects these kids on the field. Do you think it will have an impact on today's ball game?
Oh, I think it'll definitely have an impact on the game. You know, right now in a rivalry, it's ratcheted up to 10. This will take it to 11. Where the officials better be careful is during the pregame warm-up, the teams have to actually share parts of the field. They get close to each other, but the officials better have their hands on the flag early in this game.
The Wolfpack certainly coming in with momentum, having won the past four straight games versus the Tar Heels. For more on this history and the quarterback play, we send it to Steve Martin and Dave Archer.
Well, thanks, Danielle. There's been a lot going on between the two coaching staffs over the week in this rivalry, but Looking at the big picture, Dave, and you were in Iowa State, you played Iowa, you go through it. This is a rivalry that divides neighborhoods and households.
It really is. Two teams that have a lot of pride. Guys played against each other in high school, Steve, and a lot of times it doesn't really matter what's going on outside this building. This is one of the biggest rivalries in this part of the country. These kids are keyed up for it.
And, of course, last year's game kind of fed into this rivalry. It was one of the closer ones in the 100 games that have been played between these two. T.J. Graham got turned the game around with this big 87-yard punt return.
Huge punt return by T.J. Graham really put the game in the favor of NC State. A late two-point throw by T.J. Yates falls in the hands of an NC State player, and that's it. It's all over. NC State wins for the fourth time in the series in a row.
And coming into this game, of course, trying to look for number five, NC State will rely on the arm of Mike Glennon, who's stepping into the position this year and has done a pretty good job.
He really's done a great job. When you figure the scrutiny this guy's been under with Russell Wilson moving on, Glennon's done an outstanding job. 19 touchdowns, only 8 interceptions, and really played his best game probably against Virginia a couple of weeks ago. Struggled a little bit against Florida State a week ago. Brent Renner, the number 6 rated passer in the country, number 1 in the ACC, has done an outstanding job of filling in for a great T.J. Yates. The kid is really taking care of the ball well.
And had a great week against Wake Forest last week in 21 out of 28 on the afternoon. Danielle, it ought to be a great one between these two. Two good quarterbacks, a great interstate rivalry, two coaches who've been jawing each other all week. What more could you ask for?
UNC, NC State coach, give me keys for both ball games.
Right now, North Carolina must be Giovanni Bernard rushing. NC State, Mike Glennon must eliminate turnovers. For Maryland right now, they've got to stop the run. For Virginia, Mike Rocco must manage the offense perfectly.
That does it for us in the ACC Network studios. He's Tommy Bowden. I'm Danielle Trotta. Thanks for joining us. Enjoy the first half of your ball game.
Three things have been certain under Tom O'Brien at NC State: death, taxes, and football wins over the Tar Heels. Coach Everett Withers would like to teach the Wolfpack how it feels to lose a game in this series. Definitely no love lost here. Now that sounds like my kind of party. And it's that kind of rivalry. It's the one that divides households, people on the street. You mix and mingle with them all year long. And finally, the men with the pads and the helmets will come out and decide this game. It's the 101st meeting between North Carolina and North Carolina State at Carter-Finley Stadium. Welcome to the ACC Network. And it's been a noisy week in this rivalry, as both coaches didn't have to do much to stoke the interest. One said, my school's better than yours. The other says, no, that's not the case, and so be it. But on the field, they will decide it this afternoon. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Steve Martin here along with Dave Archer. It's been one of those rivalry weeks. There are 58,000 fans in this stadium, and this will probably be the only game they remember all year.
Well, you got a lot of passion in the stands. You've got guys that have played against each other in high school. They're going to play in this game. And, oh, by the way, the coaches threw gasoline on it as well. This is going to be a good one.
And, of course, it's going to be determined on the field by some guys who really are game changers. And for North Carolina, of course, it's been a great year for freshman running back Giovanni Bernard.
He's been spectacular, Steve. They needed a ground attack to help their young quarterback, Brent Renner, but it's Giovanni Bernard. 6 100-yard games on the year. He's the leading rusher as a freshman in the country, leading rushing freshman in the country. He's done an outstanding job of taking care of the football. You look on the other side of the football, and you've got one of the top corners in all of college football. Leads the country in interceptions. He's had 3 games where he's intercepted 2 passes in a game. This kid is a ball hawk. Renner will have to be careful about throwing it in Amerson's way.
David Amerson brought one to the house against Virginia a couple of weeks ago. Dave, let's take a look at our 4 keys to the game.
Well, we know the key for North Carolina: run, Gio, run. Gio Ronnie Bernard has been outstanding. We talked about 6 100-yard games. They need to get him running. Very patient runner. Look for him to have a big day today for North Carolina. For NC State, guess what? They've got a syllabus here, and Tom O'Brien gave it to them. They've won this game 4 games in a row. Follow that syllabus to get number 5.
Let's go to the sidelines. Third member of the broadcast crew, Scott Przewanski, and he's talking initials and the hidden yardage department.
Yeah, and you know, Steve, sometimes in games like this, special teams can be the difference, and we've got 2 playmakers who are looking to do just that. For NC State, it's T.J. Graham, the veteran. He needs just 76 yards to become the ACC He's all-time kickoff return yardage leader. He can flat-out fly with the football. For North Carolina, it's a true freshman, T.J. Thorpe. He's already gone 100 yards for a score this year. He leads the conference in kickoff return yardage. But he's had a propensity to put the ball on the floor at times as well. Either way, we've got two T.J.'s, both from the state of North Carolina, and both looking to have an impact here today.
Thank you very much, Scott. ACC football brought to you in high definition by H.H. Gregg. Larger selection, lower prices, smarter associates. H.H. Gregg, we help. Well, we welcome you to the field of battle. North Carolina will kick off. They've won the toss, and they are deferring to the second half. Moore with a kickoff, and T.J. Graham, one of the best there is, has returned two in his career for touchdowns, and he gives them excellent field position on a 22-yard return to the 39. Here's a look at our starting lineups now for NC State. Of course, Washington is their chief running back, James Washington. They've had a lot of injuries there. Jay Smith, T.J. Graham, George Bryan, their receivers up front. The veteran offensive line led over there at left tackle by R.J. Mattis, Christoph Wenz, who's an excellent center, and Overgaard and Allen. And here is Mike Glennon, fourth-year junior out of Centerville, Virginia. And his first play of the game is a pass to the flats to Tobias Palmer, and it's going to be incomplete. Let's take a look at the defense now. Starting lineups, North Carolina, great front four. Copels will play on Sunday. Martin, Powell, and Williams in the secondary, actually in the linebacker. Zach Brown's a great one. Reddick and Lippert has moved into the starting lineup. Charles Brown, the veteran, out back with Jonathan Smith, Trey Boston, and true freshman, Tim Scott. Second down and 10, Glennon's pass, this one at the foot of James Washington.
Good pressure again, this time Zach Brown, you mentioned, an outstanding football player, number 47. We'll see him all day long for North Carolina in the NC State backfield. This kid, he will blitz. He does an outstanding job of getting sideline to sideline. He is a big-time football player. Great speed at the linebacker spot, at the spot with Zach Brown. Mike Glennon's done a nice job, Steve, of really kind of settling in this spot under the microscope. With Russell Wilson moving on, he says they still talk to one another. He's done an outstanding job of taking care of the ball.
Third play of the game is an interception. Charles Brown picks it off and goes to the ground at the 39-yard line. So three passes for NC State, and the third of the three is picked off. And for Brown, that's his second pickoff this season.
Well, this is just a fade route, and what happens is Mike Glennon throws the ball too far up the field. This needed to be a back shoulder throw. He threw the ball up the field, and Charles Brown, who missed all of last year with all the suspensions and everything that went on with the academic problems at North Carolina, Charles Brown back on the field, and he's paid big dividends for him at the corner spot.
Quick change now. North Carolina's offense takes the field for the first time. Giovanni Bernard, and there is Bryn Renner. Sophomore, third-year sophomore out of the state of Virginia, as well as Mike Glennon. And here's Bernard. And he needs 35 yards to eclipse the 1,000 mark. And he's got a good chunk of that here on the first play, about 12 yards, 13 actually. Earl Wolf on the tackle for the Wolfpack.
This is one of the most patient runners you'll see in all of college football. Look at him press the hole, waits for it to happen. He gets lost behind this massive offensive line. He has been a spectacular redshirt freshman out of Florida.
Won a couple of state championships at St. Thomas Aquinas High School. Ran into injury problems. ACL in his first year here. He had a hamstring his senior year in high school. Renner play action. And his pass is complete. And it is going to be very close to a first down. Dwight Jones gets it. Let's take a look at the Tar Heels offense here. You saw Dwight Jones. He's a leading receiver with 54. Eric Highsmith is there with him. Nelson Hurst is the tight end. Bernard, and then, of course, Christian Wilson in the backfield. Up front, James Hurst, Jonathan Cooper, center Cam Holland, Travis Bond, and Brennan Williams. And in the front four for NC State. This will be the second time this season that they've had the same starting lineup as far as defensive linemen are concerned. Injuries have just scarred NC State defensively. They're not as good as the team that compiled a 9-4 record a year ago, but they're getting better. 10-yard gain on that play. Chain gang comes in, and so that'll move North Carolina to the NC State 38.
Excellent job on the bootleg play there. Whenever you get a ground attack cranked up, you get an opportunity.
Across the front, Slade, Kuhn, Sweezy, and Norman, who's a good one.
And of course, Maddox steps into a starting spot with Audie Cole and Terrell Manning. And there you see the back, Amerson, Bishop, Wolf, and Smith. Handoff on first and 10, and it's going nowhere. It's an end around to Jeremy Boyd, and Jay Boyd is set for a loss of 2 on the play. The tackle made by Dwayne Maddox.
Yeah, big time play though by Brian Sway, the defensive end. Sway, 55, is going to penetrate right there and cut him off. And that allows Maddox to get in and make the tackle. But a great play that time by Brian Sway on the defensive edge.
North Carolina looking at second down and 12. They've picked off a pass from Mike Lennon, and they're trying to take advantage of it here. Play action again. And pursuit of the quarterback, Audie Cole, sacks Renner. He loses the ball, still loose. Looks like North Carolina's got it. But it's for a big loss on the play.
It looked like Maddox had a chance to scoop and score here, but couldn't quite get the ball in his hands. Here comes Audie Cole, 42, straight through the middle. Outstanding speed. Used to play outside, now the inside. The ball comes loose. And right there, you see 41. Maddox had a chance for a scoop and score right here and just couldn't get down to get to it. Renner does a good job of hustling back and getting on top of the football.
It's a loss of 27. It's going to be third and 39. I don't care what you've got for a third down percentage. There aren't many playbook or plays in John Shoup's playbook, the offensive coordinator, that'll bring in this one. Let's see what happens. Renner, screen pass, complete. And that's going to be to Bernard, and not much yardage there. Just a little more room for the punter. Gain of about 4 on the pass to Bernard, who happens to be the second leading receiver. Dante Johnson on the tackle for NC State. So the Wolfpack avoid any trouble from the interception, and they're going to get the ball back. Thomas Hibbert, freshman. We got a lot of freshmen in here for both sides kicking the football. Hibbert getting ready to kick, and T.J. Graham has brought 2 back and 1 against North Carolina in this series, and that's going to be kicked out of bounds. North Carolina will try to avoid kicking to T.J. Graham today. Well, get your game face on. This rivalry in its 101st running is full tilt. It's been so all week long. The coaches greet each other. No score in Raleigh. ACC football is being brought to you by AT&T, by CPI Security Systems, by BMW, by Longhorn Steakhouse, and by Liberty Mutual Insurance. That might be the only way you get me to eat cabbage is if you throw it on the grill. And we are here in Raleigh at Carter-Finley Stadium. Both teams have had a chance to have the football. The punt by C.J. Fiegels. Fiegels punted that last ball. It was 27 yards. And that was the length of the loss by Bryn Renner when he went back and fumbled the ball. Now NC State. It's going to be Washington. He is brought down at the 41-yard line. And that's the big thing, Arch, about NC State this year. Why Glennon's haven't worked so hard, they really haven't had a running game to speak of to back him up.
Yeah, they've had a lot of injuries in the backfield. James Washington has been a pleasant surprise. The junior out of Orlando has given them a bit of a running game, averaging 4.0 a carry, but it hasn't been enough. And if they can get any kind of running game going, nice pickup there, 5 yards, certainly gives Glennon an opportunity to make some plays.
Mustafa Green was the guy that they had counted on, and he's out for the season with a leg injury. And here's Washington again, carrying bodies with him for the first down, out a yard shy of midfield to the 49-yard line. Tackle made by Kareem Martin.
This is a good job of coming off behind this offensive line. Boy, very athletic offensive line. We'll talk more and more about the center. Camden Wentz, number 53, was an outstanding job of directing traffic up front. But James Washington, 2 back-to-back runs. And now all of a sudden, North Carolina has to start crowding it a little bit with their linebackers. Gives him an opportunity for play action.
Here's Glennon. Here's Washington again, 3rd straight carry. They passed the ball the first 3 times they had the ball. And this series, they featured James Washington 3 straight times. He runs into the embrace of Zach Brown. Tom O'Brien, he's done a great job wherever he's been, and you talked about the center position. He's developed some great centers, and centers play a key role in what they want to do.
Yeah, and especially in this front where you're going to see a, what I call an even front, where they'll try not to cover up the center, or they won't cover up the center from time to time. This is an over front here with the center cover.
Here's Glennon. Glennon felt some pressure from behind from Dante Page Moss, and he is tackled by Page Moss. Sack, loss of three.
That's the 20th sack on the year for this North Carolina defense. They're third in the ACC in sacks. And they've got some big timers. Copel's 90 forces the play, and then Page Moss comes off the backside to make the play. He had an outstanding year a year ago. Seven sacks for Dante Page Moss a year ago.
And sharing that position with Kareem Martin off that right defensive end spot. Glennon to throw on third down and eight. Has a man out there. That is Tobias Palmer. Looks like he caught it off the shoulder of the defensive back, and it's good for a first down after a 26-yard gain. Trey Boston was out there defending.
Now, North Carolina jumped up in bump and run man-to-man coverage, and Trey Boston, who's moved over from corner to safety. Here he is in the slot. Just a little corner out. Ball underthrown, but an outstanding job of concentration by Palmer. He dropped the first pass of the game on a little screen. This one a tougher catch, and he makes a great play.
First and 10, Washington again. They carry it down to the 20-yard line. Tackle made by Clinton Colbus. Gain of about four. NC State digging up some yardage now in the ground game, and it sets them up in pretty good shape. As Art said, he's a junior, Washington from Orlando, Florida, went to Boone High School. And we're going to get our first look at Tony Creasy this afternoon. Sure, freshman.
Run a little bit behind that right side. Zach Allen, 21 consecutive starts. Michael Overgaard, eight starts this year.
Pass to Tobias Palmer. Complete. He's got the first down inside the 15 to the 13-yard line. Gene Robinson on the tackle, but it's a gain of eight, and it'll move the chains for the Wolfpack.
You have an opportunity. Dana Bible, outstanding offensive football coach, has a chance to mix things now. When you start talking about running the football, now you can throw it a little bit. We look at the CPI red zone defensively for North Carolina. They've been very good. Only 14 touchdowns and 30 possessions in the red zone.
Only 22 scores. Play action now for Glennon. He'll go over the middle into the end zone. Touchdown! Tobias Palmer. No, that's T.J. Graham. Graham with the touchdown on the first play inside the 15.
Now, play action fake. Talked about it. You run the ball a little bit. Now you can throw over the top of that intermediate coverage. And he wins to the inside versus Tim Scott, the corner, the freshman. T.J. Graham skies up and makes the catch. Outstanding job. His fifth touchdown catch of the year.
His 14th in his career. That includes both the punt returns and the kickoff returns. Nicholas Sadie in for the point after. And the kick is good, and the Wolfpack spring on top again. It's their accustomed role in this rivalry. They've won four straight, and they're up 7-0 on the target. Now the fans are pretty happy here at Carter-Finley Stadium. Wolfpack have scored 7-0. T.J. Graham on a 12-yard pass reception. Eight plays, 64 yards. It featured James Washington on four carries and 22 of those 68 yards.
Yeah, what a great mix of run and pass that time by Dana Bible, the offensive coordinator for NC State. Now you got the matchup with NC State, who is 11th in the ACC in kickoff coverage, versus T.J. Thorpe, who averages almost 30 yards a return. This is an area that Tom O'Brien was very concerned about.
Well, one back 100 yards for a touchdown against Clemson. He'll fumble this at the 8. Flag thrown into the play, and he meets the wall at the 27-yard line. It's going to be a 20-yard return, but likely he's going to be pulled back a little bit. Tom Zamorski is our official.
Throwing the return, blocking the back, 29, the senior team. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
Let's take a look at that touchdown again on Mike Glennon's 20th touchdown pass.
Yeah, here's T.J. Graham. He's going to run the post in here. I want you to see what happens to this defender and this defender versus the play action. Watch him freeze with play action. They don't get the depth they need. In behind them goes T.J. Graham. Excellent throw from Glennon. And that's what running the football will do for you, give you that opportunity to go over the top.
That's kind of uncharacteristic for North Carolina with the way that they have been in the red zone. They pretty much got their assignments all taken care of, but that time they did not. Bryn Renner hands off now to Bernard. And Bernard gets up over the 10. The penalty dragged them back to about the 7-yard line. Audie Cole, 5th-year senior out of Monroe, Michigan, in on the tackle. Cole, as Art said, is a guy who played outside linebacker and watched Nate Irving at middle linebacker last year and learned quite a bit, he said yesterday in our conference with him.
Originally arrived as a quarterback here at NC State, shifted to linebacker, and now he's the quarterback of the defense.
That was going to go to Central Michigan with Brian Kelly, but he moved out of there and went to Notre Dame. Here comes Bernard again, and he is stopped right about the line of scrimmage. Terrell Manning, the junior out of Laurinburg, North Carolina.
North Carolina came in today giving up 160 yards on the ground. Today, the yardage have been tough to come by for Giovanni Bernard since his first carry. But Terrell Manning, number 35 right there, and Audie Cole, 42, outstanding linebackers. And now what you do is you dial, Mike Archer has the opportunity to dial up some of their exotic pressure packages. You're not sure where they're coming from. They do a great job of breaking down your protection.
You got Cato Bishop and Franson as the ends. Renner to throw to the flats and overthrows Dwight Jones.
When you got the blitz off the slot, you didn't know where it was going to come from. But they did a good job of bringing people, forced Renner to throw the ball a little bit quicker than he wanted to. And this guy's been extremely accurate this year, completing almost 73% of his throws. And it forced him into an inaccurate throw there.
Well, the man who started as punter last year is going to be back there this time around. He was the last time. There's T.J. Graham in receipt of the punt from sophomore C.J. Fiegels. Last year averaged 37.5. Lost his job earlier in the season to Thomas Hibbard, but the punt game has been, the specialty game on both sides has been troublesome at best. Graham will call for the fair catch at the 47-yard line. It's a 36-yard punt with no return. And there's Mike Glennon. 20 touchdown passes, already got one today. As you put the Wolfpack on top, back after this from your local ACC station. It's bow time all around ACC campuses during football weekends, and the bow tailgaters were out early this morning here at Carter-Finley Stadium getting ready for the game today. Don't forget to pick up your 12-piece Super Tailgate Special from Bojangles in the big new bow box. Remember, it's always bow time when you're tailgating. You need a little Cajun heat from that Cajun chicken here to keep you warm today. We're barely pushing 50. Tony Creasy's in the ballgame. Backfield at the running back spot. Alternating with James Washington. That's Graham in motion, and here's Creasy. And Creasy finds his way to the North Carolina 37-yard line. Trey Boston in on the tackle. Let's take a look at that last drive. But wait a minute, we've got the player down here first.
It's Charles Brown, the corner.
And that could be a tough loss for them.
Well, he was working against T.J. Graham, and actually Graham really did a good job of blocking on the edge. And once they released, then Charles Brown took a couple steps and then went down, clutching his left shoulder.
Everett Withers has had to deal with a lot of injuries on his defense as well. Lost Matt Merletti for the season. Charles Brown, of course, missed all of last season, serving out NCAA suspension. And they were glad to see him back this year. He's done very well. He's already intercepted the pass here this afternoon.
It's kind of a delayed reaction. I was watching the Graham block, who was out in front of the play. And you see it right here on the right side of the screen. See, got him a little tied up. And as he steps away, then he'll clutch his shoulder and go to the ground. Really good contact there. He takes a couple steps and then he grabs the shoulder. So got tied up there. Boy, he's been a really good player for North Carolina this year coming back. His senior season, senior out of Cleveland, Ohio.
And in here with 40 tackles, 5 of them for loss, and now 2 interceptions. Let's take a look at its last drive, Arch, by NC State. It's a good mix.
Yeah, it really was a good blend. Dana Bible got the ground game cranked up. Of course, got the really good throw on third down to Tobias Palmer. Another throw to Tobias Pullman, then the good solid play action fake, and TJ Graham over the top with the circus catch in the back of the end zone.
Glennon has been very effective with the amount of times that he's had to throw. Here's the pass to the flats out there to Tobias Palmer, who's caught three balls so far this afternoon. And the tackle made by Tim Scott after a five-yard gain.
Yeah, we see it all the time, Steve. You got to get blocks on the edge. This time, Jay Smith, 86, is going to try to get the block for Tobias Palmer. Really doesn't do a very good job, but Palmer hits it straight up the field. And so it's an extension of the run game. They get six out of it and five out of the play.
Glennon to throw again, this time to the opposite side of the field, and this not nearly as successful to Tony Creasy coming in to make the play. Freshman Tim Scott, that's a couple of plays that we've seen this true freshman out of Fredericksburg, Virginia, come in to make.
Yeah, Tim Scott kind of jumped into the starting lineup because of his play. Did an outstanding job of getting himself on the field as a freshman.
And the injury to Jabari Price helped him out there. Here's the pass to George Bryan. His 14th reception of the season. Boston on the tackle. He's got enough for the first down. An 8-yard gain.
It's a good play by George Bryan because he's short of the first down when he catches the football. Now he's got to fight for it. He fights through the tackle of Trey Boston and picks up the first down. The crowd here acknowledged his effort, realizing the good second effort by George Bryan. All-time leading tight end receiver in NC State history.
Out of the 22 in North Carolina, first and 10. In motion, that's Underwood. Handoff now comes to Creasy, and he is hauled down, although met initially hard and then finally hauled down. Loss of three on the play.
Kevin Reddick, we talked about these two linebackers, number 48. Reddick reads it and hits it. He doesn't wait. Does it flow down the line of scrimmage? He saw the crease and he hit it. Good job. Reddick and Brown, 48 and 47, outstanding linebackers. They're great speed, great instincts. Of course, when you have Quan Sturdivant and Bruce Carter in front of you, you're going to learn a little bit about how to play linebacker at North Carolina.
We've had some good ones over the years, that's for sure. Second down now and about 13 for the Wolfpack. Back to the 25. Pressure on, Copel's there. Also Tydrick Powell, and he ends up bringing down Mike Glennon for the second sack of the day.
Copel is just a monster coming off the edge. Copel came in today with 4.5 sacks, giving probably at least a half on this one as he wraps up. Powell will get the other half, but a good job by Copel with the speed rush off the edge, and now you have third and long. For Tom O'Brien now, having schooled his quarterback, Mike Glennon, they're trying to get themselves in field goal range here.
Now they're moving in reverse. They're at the 33 after the loss of 8 on the sack. Draw play goes to Washington, who picks up a little bit of yardage now. They'll get up to the 31-yard line. Getting yourself into Nicholas Sadie's kicking range here. True freshman out of Wake Forest, North Carolina. History goes there. Of course, Wake Forest's original location was in Wake Forest, North Carolina. They moved since the Winston-Salem.
I think they want a little more out of that play. Only got 2 yards out of the play. Zach Brown made the play.
This is a totally freshman lineup and operation. Long snapper Scott Thompson. The holder is Will Bauman. And it is Nick Rossetti for a 48-yarder. This would be a career high for him. Kick is up. And it crosses, just right. Sadie had the distance, didn't have much range on it, but it would have crossed over the crossbar had it been dead down the middle, but it was not. McAllister's Deli is giving two lucky guests each a Jeep Wrangler. Register at Facebook.com/TFreaks for official rules, entry form, and great weekly tailgate prizes. That's Facebook.com/TFreaks. And you could be a winner. Really sweet ride.
Really a blown opportunity there for North Carolina State with a short field. Big loss on the Copel set.
First and 10 for the Tar Heels. They hold with a missed field goal. They've got the ball. First and 10 passes incomplete to Dwight Jones. Let's go back to our ACC Network studios in Charlotte and Danielle Trotter.
Thanks so much, Steve. In this Hyundai update, UVA at Maryland. Cavaliers need one more win to go bowling, and Perry Jones strikes first. A 47-yard touchdown makes it 7-0 UVA, just under 6 to go in the first.
Interesting game at College Park this afternoon. Thank you very much, Danielle. Second down now and 10 coming for the Tar Heels. Bernard on the carry. He follows Cam Holland, but there's not much yardage out there. Dwayne Maddox and Earl Wolf stop him after about a one-yard gain.
Now, NC State is playing on North Carolina's side of the football. Watch for the penetration now. Outstanding job of getting upfield by Maddox first. Really took away Giovanni Bernard's opportunity to get to the outside. And once he cut it inside, here comes Adi Cole.
Well, it's a 4-3 look, but NC State will always have five men in the line of scrimmage. They'll be blitzing one just about every time. And a 4-1 alignment now. Renner back to throw. Guns, and it is dropped. That is Boyd on the drop. That brings up fourth down. So three and out for the Tar Heels here. That would have made it to the first down.
It's just a deep curl route, and Renner has to eat one to let this one go. It's a well-thrown football. You're not going to get one better than that. As Jay Boyd drops it, and now North Carolina punts. But when your quarterback gets hit in the back, to wait and throw a ball like that, you got to make a catch.
C.J. Gray back to get the punt. C.J. Fiegels to kick it. North Carolina.
C.J. Fiegels, the son of one of the great punters in NFL history, Jeff Fiegels.
Long here, 22 years. Long time as a punter in the NFL. Graham calls for a fair catch, and this is the worst field position for the Wolfpack. After a 41-yard kick, there's no return. Champion presents Home Team Traditions. For the last 9 years, the players and coaches take their traditional walk past the Wolfpack turf statues in front of the Murphy Football Center. The 28-foot statue was created by former state football player and master sculptor Dick Idle. It's made up of six wolves, each with a name representing one of six characteristics of an NC State football player. Join the conversation online. Show us your game face and share your game day traditions. Champion, it's how you play. Tom, Brian knows a little bit about tradition. Coaching in the Army Navy series, you tend to. Glennon off his back foot. Fires one, hopefully, to the tuba section. As T.J. Graham was covered by just about everybody who was in secondary for North Carolina.
They talk about Tom O'Brien. I do a radio show, Steve, as you know, in Atlanta every week, and had some callers call in, and we were talking about Tom O'Brien this week, and obviously everything went on, and he defended his school and his reign here. And I said, yeah, the former Marine and head coach of NC State, and I got about 10 phone calls. There is no such thing as a former Marine.
And you know, when you sit down and talk to the man, they're very happy. He was very succinct in his comments this week. Tony Creasy on the carry, a 4-yard gain. Tim Jackson, who backs up Quentin Copeland at the defensive end spot, comes in for the tackle. Both teams using some liberal substitutions on their defensive line.
Tom talked about this week about how it's about the football game. It's not about what went on Wednesday or anything like that. He is a big-time college football coach. He's done an outstanding job everywhere he's been.
Sacking with George Welch. Navy and Virginia. Here's the pass again by Renner, this time going to Tobias Palmer. And into a zone with a lot of Tar Heels here. Robinson and Scott in on the play. That's a three and out series here for the Wolfpack.
Now, nice switch up that time by North Carolina. They showed the same look pre-snap. And that was the throw. Remember, Tobias Palmer caught the corner route earlier in the last drive, but this time they switched the coverage up, and the corner bails right back into it. No place to throw it.
Punt return is an adventure for North Carolina. Charles Brown has taken over that spot. Bauman on the kick. He's a true freshman, and that was an adventure as well. The ball takes a Wolfpack roll down to about the 30-yard line. It's going to be a 40-yard kick. ACC fans, AT&T wants to give you the chance to take your team to the top of Buzz Rankings. Visit BuzzRankings.com to watch your team's social media buzz climb. The more buzz you can create for your school on Facebook, Twitter, and Foursquare, the higher your team climbs in the rankings. AT&T is the exclusive wireless partner of the Atlantic Coast Conference, keeping you in the game with all the action at home or on the go. Bryn Renner looking to get out of the blocks here for North Carolina. A tough start for him.
Yeah, they need to find a way to get this group blocked up front and get Giovanni Bernard rolling.
There's Bernard, and he's going to go back to throw. Might want to rethink that. And he has brought down Adi Cole.
the charge. Dwayne Maddox completes it.
Yeah, Adi Cole read it and didn't hesitate. He immediately hit it. He was coming up to work against the run and saw Giovanni Bernard pull it up and throw it. 42 is going to hit it right now. He didn't wait. Came right through the hole and was all over Bernard before he could load it up and throw it. They had a one-man route. They had Dwight Jones streaking down the field. But a good job of North Carolina taking away the throw. And Everett Withers trying to figure out, how do I get my young running back rolling?
Last year, the Tar Heels were minus 7 in rushing against NC State, losing that game 29-25. Play action. Renner out on the edge, being pursued, fires it on the North Carolina bench. Dwight Jones, the intended receiver, Wilson in the area as well.
North Carolina State came in today because of a lot of injuries, and Mike Archer said, we just haven't played as well as we did a year ago. That ninth in the ACC in total defense, but they have been all over North Carolina here early going, as you see those the first three series of the game for the Tar Heels.
Punter, the only one generating positive yardage at this point. North Carolina, yards rushing minus 20 as we count down the time here in the first quarter. 24 seconds to go, and now North Carolina wants a timeout to talk things over. It always troubles a head coach when you call a timeout 24 seconds ahead of ending the quarter. Ren Renner didn't like what he saw, so he's going to come over and talk with Evan Withers. Let's take a look at our Cavalier defensive shield. The Wolfpack defensively, they lead the country in takeaways. They forced 23 turns. That's fifth in the NCAA. They have 15 interceptions and 8 fumble recoveries. And, of course, Dave Amerson is the guy who leads them in interceptions this year. He has 2 more than his closest pursuer with 8 on the season. But up next Saturday, we'll follow the Wolfpack to Boston. And it's always a great series when Tom O'Brien gets a chance to go home and coach against the team that he served for 10 or 11 years, the Boston College Eagles. There at 12 noon, Tim Grant, Dave Archer, and Mike Hogwood on the sidelines at Alumni Stadium in Chestnut Hill, Massachusetts. Third down coming now. Tar Heels in reverse, Bernard in the backfield. Yardage to get is 19. 7-0 NC State. Renner, most time he's had to throw today, going deep, and it is picked off. Wolf, his second interception of the senior for the junior from Rayford, North Carolina.
Well, he had a chance to throw the football down the field, and this is I've been wondering about this a little bit. Scott Przewanski, who's down on the sideline, Scott's been down there in some of the weather, and there's a lot of wind blowing. Scott, this looks like a ball that really the wind knocked down.
Yeah, you know, Arx, that's the first one we've seen a deep ball by Renner that wasn't a tight spiral, wasn't a tight, crisp pass. You could see when it got in the air. There's a gust down here, and I think it caught it on that. Something to keep an eye on for sure. You know it's difficult with the wind blowing, Arx.
Each team's got a turnover here. This is basically serves the purpose of a punt. Washington, the running back, and he bulls his way for about 5 or 6.
Lord knows I've thrown a few ducks into the wind. You've got to really spin the ball. You really have to be tight with the spiral, and that time it got a little distorted. As Scott Ted said, it held it up in the wind.
A 17 mile an hour wind, to be exact. Our statistician Freddie Kiger has a homemade anemometer in his finger. We have reached the end of the first quarter of play at Carter-Finley Stadium. The 101st renewal of this rivalry between NC State and North Carolina. The Wolfpack with the early lead in Raleigh by 7. Guest of honor at the barbecue right there, and that is True Honest Pork Barbecue. And there's one right outside the door here at Carter-Finley Stadium. Great place to watch a college football game. A beautiful day, albeit chilly. We talked about the wind. We're starting in the second quarter here. NC State with the ball up 7-0. Mike Glennon pass caught nicely there by Underwood. That is Brian Underwood, who burst onto the scene in the Virginia game, starting in place of T.J. Graham, who was disciplined in the first half. Good play. Our first quarter stats brought to you by Mazda. We believe if it's not worth driving, well, it's not worth building. And North Carolina's trying to build a running game, and that's not going very well. 7 total yards.
Yeah, NC State is really, and I mentioned it the first quarter, is playing on North Carolina's side of the football. And they've got to find a way to cut down on the penetration and get Giovanni Bernard rolling.
And after the second series, where North Carolina State was able to move the ball on the ground, James Washington runs headlong into Trey Boston for a very short game of about 2 yards, give or take.
I don't think they got that, Steve. Looked like they got about length of football, but that's all they needed probably for a first down.
That's what they got.
Glennie got off to kind of a slow start, and 2 of those 3 that were incomplete were dropped, and the other one was intercepted. But since then, 7 of 9, including the 12-yard touchdown pass to T.J. Graham, they've done just enough in the ground game to kind of slow North Carolina down where he could throw it.
Washington to the 2 tight end side. Gets close to midfield, maybe about a yard shy. It'll be a 3-yard gain. Jordan Nix, receiver from Watkin, Oklahoma, in on the tackle for North Carolina.
This defensive front for North Carolina, see several of these guys playing at the next level. But they've had a tough time matching up the secondary with all the injuries to their pass rush. They're very good rush to the passer. But if you can't keep people to hold on the ball a little bit, then they're not going to be able to get there.
And off here again to Washington. He gets past the 50 into North Carolina territory. Run down by Zach Brown after a 2-yard gain. And that gets him to the North Carolina 48-yard line. So here comes the Wolfpack again. Powered by an interception. That interception's reach side. Earl Wolf has one for NC State. Charles Brown, who incidentally is back in the ballgame now for North Carolina. So glad to see that.
You look at Mike Glennon right there. Glennon, the first 2 years he played here at North Carolina State, only played 10 games. Only threw 52 passes his first 2 years, but really settled in. He's done a nice job. Tom O'Brien had a lot of belief in this young man, and he's really shown up.
His business administration degree after 3 years. Pass to the flats is incomplete, intended for Jay Smith. That'll bring the punting unit on 4th down and 4.
Yeah, good coverage by Tim Scott, the true freshman. Scott's right there, disrupts the throw right at the end. Little offline that time by Glennon, tough catch for Jay Smith. But Tim Scott, outstanding job there, the true freshman from Fredericksburg, Virginia.
Will Bauman is going to kick to Tim Scott and Charles Brown. And Brown will let it go, trying to get it into the end zone. It doesn't. Takes an NC State bounce. It'll be recovered at the 9-yard line. It's a 38-yard punt. There's no return, and North Carolina will be starting in the shadow of their end zone. Bryn Renner trying to get to work. The sophomore from Virginia has his work cut out for him, down 7 to the Wolfpack. ACC football is brought to you by GMC, by John Deere, by CPI Security Systems, and by Champion. City skyline of North Carolina's second largest city, Raleigh, North Carolina, also the state capital. North Carolina with the football, and here comes Giovanni Bernard. He's trying to shake loose. Bernard came in here leading 35 yards to get to 1,000. And he now has 4 yards of that gain, and the Wolfpack defense has been one reason why it's been tough.
Now, it's been like a pack of wolves, no question about it. They've been all over North Carolina from the opening gun. Giovanni Bernard has found no running room. And then, of course, it ended the last drive with the Wolf interception. But they've held up their end of the bargain defensively, no question.
Carolina's team rushing at minus 16 after that 4-yard gain. Quick pass. Get them some room out there on the perimeter. And that is going to be Dwight Jones. North Carolina usually enjoys a lot of success. They've outscored their opponents in the first quarter 49-0 in 6 wins. However, in their 3 losses, they've been outscored 30-14. Outscored 7-0 here by NC State in this game.
where it stands right now. First and 10. Hand off Bernard. And Bernard was clotheslined as he got past the line of scrimmage, maybe picked up a yard. Audie Cole in there on the tackle.
Yeah, Audie Cole, a semifinalist for the Butkus Award, number 42, steps inside, beats the block of the guard, and makes the play. Really been an outstanding transition for Audie Cole. Played outside linebacker, did an outstanding job, tied for the team lead in tackles last year with Nate Irving. Slid right inside, and he leads the team in tackles as an inside linebacker.
Talk a minute about some of the things he told us yesterday. I thought one comment was very key about anticipation. Here's Renner. His pass into traffic is complete. Renner looking to the short ball and looking to Dwight Jones, his leading receiver, to help punch out some yardage and running room here out to the 25-yard line. You know, Audie Cole said yesterday, we study each other so well that when we get out to the line, we pretty much know what the other team is going to run. But the key is, can you keep the offensive center off Audie Cole in the middle so we can make the tackle? North Carolina 0 for 4 on third down. Pass is complete. There's a flag on the play. Dwight Jones in a foot race with the secondary heading down the field for a big gain that could go to a touchdown. Bryn Renner is down in the backfield. The Tar Heels have scored pending the flag.
That's a hold.
And it looks like it's coming back. Brennan Williams, the guilty party. Brent Renner gets up off the field.
Well, he took a big shot just as he let this one go, but it looks like Audie Cole comes off the edge to make this hit. Coming out of the right there, big hit from Audie Cole. We just talked about his ability to do a lot of things for this team, but this was Renner's best throw of the game. Little skinny post to the inside to Dwight Jones. And then Jones showed why he is one of the best in the country. Great speed, but it all comes back. And that one makes it even, that makes that hit hurt even worse when you don't get the back end of the play when it comes back on a holding penalty.
Third and 16 coming up now for North Carolina. Take the six off the board. They are 0 for 5 in third down. Renner, short pass, tipped. Tipped by Terrell Manning. Once again, the Tar Heel offense is thwarted by a solid Wolfpack defensive effort.
How about Terrell Manning? Outstanding athlete. Plays that outside, short outside linebacker or weak side linebacker. Just reads the eyes of Renner. Terrell Manning missed two games early in the year because midway through the season with a knee, with a minor knee surgery. Just bounced right back and playing at a high level.
Two interceptions thus far this season. Solo pass is defended. Feebles with the kick. Graham now is going to get away from it, and it takes a Wolfpack bounce in North Carolina territory. It'll come down at about the 40-yard line. It's going to be a 25-yard kick by Feebles. And no return, but the Wolfpack operating on the Tar Heel side of the field, up 7.
Danielle Trotta with your Hyundai update. Let's head to College Park, where Maryland's trying to generate some offense. This 35-yard pass to Kerry Boykin sets up a Nick Ferreira field goal. Terps on the board, but UVA leads 7-3.
Thank you very much, Danielle. Of course, Virginia, with a win, become bowl eligible today, the sixth ACC team to do so. North Carolina's already there. NC State needs to win 3 of their next 4 to get there.
North Carolina State's had great field position in this game so far, and it's only 7-0. They need to cash in some of these short field opportunities.
Average start at the NC State 42. This is their best of the day at the 39 of North Carolina. And the ball knocked around, and let's see if it was, it almost got intercepted. Sylvester Williams was in the middle of all that. Williams, a junior out of Jefferson City, Missouri.
Well, watch Zach Allen here, number 76. He's actually going to rake. This is picked off. It's intercepted, and he's going to rake the ball out. This is going to be intercepted by Tariq Powell, look like. And a good job by 76 Allen to rip the ball out. Actually, Kareem, looks like Kareem Martin had it.
Yep.
Good play by Zach Allen to switch to defender there.
Second down, we got flags all over the place here. and maybe a review.
The head coach of NC State challenges the ruling on the field that there was a catch.
Well, what they've ruled here is that there's a catch, a fumble, and an interception, a recovery of a fumbled ball. That's the catch they must be referring to, Arch.
Yeah, I don't know what they obviously didn't see it because the ball actually hits the ground, I believe, if we watch this close enough.
It's not that play. It's the play before. That play and...
That was the play that was frozen before they could... Now they're reviewing the pass play that was batted in the air. It looked like Kareem Martin had intercepted it, and Zach Allen rakes the ball out.
And the contention that Tom O'Brien has is that should be an incomplete pass.
The ball's on the ground.
Yeah.
And that's not, they just didn't see the ball hit the ground. In fact, they thought that Zach Allen had caught the football. Nobody caught the ball. The ball bounced on the ground.
Matter of fact, Kareem Martin was the one who was closest to catching the ball, but as you said, NC State was able to get the ball out of his hands and thwart the interception.
Well, I think they thought that Allen ended up with... See, he's on the ground. He ends up with the football. They didn't see the ball hit the ground. They thought that he actually took it away from Kareem Martin. And that's why they spotted the ball at the 45-yard line, thinking Kareem Allen had caught the batted ball.
Right.
Or that Zach Allen had caught the batted ball.
You were correct with the first interpretation because they thought that North Carolina had caught the deflected ball.
No. What happened was the ball is ripped. The reason it's still, if Kareem Martin had caught the football, they'd have given the ball to North Carolina. Because they thought that Allen had ended up with the football at the end of the play, that's why they spotted it. It was a 6-yard loss. The ball actually hits the ground.
Well, if they're going to mark it there, then somebody had to have possession. That's the point.
They think Zach Allen caught the football. He ended up with the football.
Wait for the ruling on the challenge. And Tom Zamorski's going to make the call right now.
After further review, the ruling on the field is an incomplete pass. The second and 10, the previous spot. Please reset the game clock to 9 minutes 54 seconds.
Well, that's a great challenge by Tom O'Brien. Remember, that play was not going to be reviewed. There was no review coming from the box. Tom O'Brien had to review that himself.
I'm amazed that they got to the line of scrimmage as quick as they did. And let's go to the sideline. Scott Przewanski, what'd you see?
Yeah, I think I saw what you guys did, and there was a lot of scrambling and a lot of talking down here as well. And you're right, Coach O'Brien was the one that he was really discussing it on the sidelines, and he's got the favorite he certainly wants for his club right now.
So it goes as an incompleted pass, which was the result that Tom O'Brien, you saw there, that was... Now he calls for the challenge. Now we got a whistle and another stoppage of play here. And we're going to take it with them. Timeout on the field. Wolfpack leading the Tar Heels. We'll be back after this message from your local ACC station. You're watching the ACC Network, an exclusive production of Raycom Sports. 78 stations strong, 62 stations on this game today. 16 stations watching the game in College Park between Maryland and Virginia. Steve Martin here, along with Dave Archer and Scott Przewanski. Second down and 10. Now we've got everything straightened out here on the second play of this drive started by the Wolfpack. Here's the handoff to Washington. And he follows Cameron Wentz for a 3-yard gain. Let's send you back to Charlotte in our ACC Network studios and Danielle Trotta.
Thanks so much, Steve. In this Hyundai update, Maryland has benched their starting quarterback, Danny O'Brien. C.J. Brown comes in and connects. It's 10-7 Terps over...
Tough season for the Maryland Terrapins. They came in with a quarterback who had an outstanding freshman year. It just doesn't seem to suit the attack. C.J. Brown on the field. And 3 of 7 on third down as the Wolfpack. And now we've got another stoppage of play. Sylvester Williams got offside.
Offside by contact. 92 of the defense. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
National recording artist Dierks Bentley headlines ACC Fan Fest. It's presented by AT&T. Get your game tickets now. And don't miss this free event held Saturday, December 3rd, prior to the ACC Football Championship. Visit accfootballcharlotte.com for tickets and more information. Big ticket sales week this week for the game in Charlotte. A lot of folks wearing Clemson orange feel they're going to be there on the first weekend of December. We'll see.
What a big mistake there by North Carolina. Make this third and short.
And here's Washington. And he'll get enough to get the first down. Turned a third and eight into a third and three. And three is what he got. Zach Brown on the tackle. That moves the chains now. As NC State spending a lot of time on the North Carolina side of the football field. Only have 7 points to show for it. They missed a 48-yard field goal the last time they got the scores. Here's Washington. And not much there. Maybe about two or three. Get himself to the 25. And for Mike Glennon, it's been an interesting day. There's been feast and famine.
Glennon started off with three incompletions and this interception, but this since then has settled in. Makes a great throw to TJ Graham that provides us with the score right now. But he really settled in, and his receivers did too.
That's downfield. Here for Palmer. And now it pushes it out to the 25. That's a 27-yard line. It's going to be third down again here for the Wolfpack. On the third down, both sides here just have been quite a bit. As the defense digs in, both sides have some pretty good defensive squads out here today. NC State, that was their calling card a year ago. They're trying to get up to that level. And they're working their way back now that they're mostly healthy. Glennon, pass complete. That's going to be to Stephen Howard, fifth-year senior out of Charlotte, North Carolina, and it's a first down now for the Wolfpack inside the red zone at the 17-yard line.
A good quick throw that time by Glennon to the slot receiver, and just a quick look inside. See the quick look inside on the slant. Excellent job, receiver and quarterback being on the same page, realizing that that was going to be a quick throw, and they pick up the first down.
First and 10, they acrobat the 18-yarder. Hand off Washington. And Washington brought down. Ball pops loose. The ruling may be that the ground caused the contact. Tackle made on the play by Charles Brown and Kareem Martin. It'll be a gain of four.
But Dana Bible is doing a really good job of mixing things up. They're just running the football enough to make North Carolina's front seven pay attention. And then they're throwing the ball with Glennon. Glennon, that quick throw and the quick slant to the slot with that front seven frozen a little bit. But a good job of mixing things. But this is a, you mentioned the field position, Steve. This is one that NC State has got to cash in.
Second down. Handoff goes to Tony Creasy. And Creasy carries the pile down to the 10. Even three more yards now. They'll set up third down and about two for the Wolfpack. Talked about Dana Bible, of course, the offensive coordinator, has been with Coach Tom O'Brien for quite a while. Diagnosed with leukemia in November of 2009. He is in remission, has been for the last 13 months. Ninth play coming in this drive. It started at the 39-yard line of North Carolina, and right now at the 10. Creasy, the long setback. He gets the handoff. And he is close to the first down. It's going to be a little bit shy, though. Needed about the 7.5. They're going to mark him down a yard short. Kevin Reddick, junior from New Bern, North Carolina.
Well, I thought they might crease him there with the running play with the young running back, but now they'll settle and go for three. They had some success running the football through the interior of North Carolina's defense. That time, North Carolina played zero coverage and had a lot of people around the line of scrimmage expect them run.
On the hold of Will Ballman, it's going to be Nicholas Sadie. 26-yard kick straight down the pipe. And it is good.
So Nicholas Sadie now is 5 for 9 field goals from the true freshman. And the Wolfpack lead it 10-0. Close captioning for ACC football brought to you by Bojangles' famous chicken and biscuits. It's bow time. Home crowd pretty happy. Their team pitching a shutout here, and I mean really. The signs are interesting. Been an interesting week. E.J. Thorpe getting ready to return the kick of Nicholas Sadie, who just kicked a 26-yard field goal to put the Wolfpack up here by 10. The return comes up short. A.J. Blue picks it up and gets it to the 33-yard line. An 18-yard gain. The ACC Network is unlocking its archives and releasing over 60 classic football games. All can be seen for free at theacc.com today. Take you back to 2002. North Carolina jumped out to a 17-7 lead before NC State quarterback Philip Rivers helped the Wolfpack to 24 unanswered points as NC State won 34-17. Relive and share your favorite ACC football moments at theacc.com/ball. Back in. Best start for the Tar Heels today. Their own 32. Renner, pass complete. It'll be to Dwight Jones. Gain of about 3. And let's go to the sidelines with more on Brent Renner by Scott Przewanski.
Yeah, Steve, one of the things some of the Carolina folks tell me about Brent Renner is he gets too amped up for games like this, and he has a hard time settling down. He's already had a fumble and interception. A lot of different players coming up to him in between series, trying to settle him down a little bit. Supposedly, he gets better as these games go on. I think he's getting in a rhythm a little bit now as well.
21 for 28 a week ago against Wake Forest and the win there. A.J. Blue on the carry. Gets out to about the 37-yard line. John Schuch said, offensive coordinator for the Tar Heels, that we'd see some A.J. Blue this afternoon.
Yeah, A.J. Blue missed all of last year with a left knee injury where he tore all the ligaments of the knee, so it's great to see him back on the field, full speed running around for the Tar Heels.
You saw that statistic, 11 plays of 0 or fewer yards for the Tar Heels. They are 0 for 5 on third down. The longest possession of the day for them has been 5. That speaks volumes of what NC State has accomplished defensively this afternoon. 10-0 Wolfpack. And Renner will call for a timeout. Bren Renner from West Springfield, Virginia, and both of our quarterbacks in this game, of course, come from the state of Virginia, and they don't live too far from each other. About 18 miles apart, the two schools that they attended, Glennett at Westfield High School in Centerville, Virginia, Bryn Renner at West Springfield High School. Renner's 2 years behind Glennett. Glennett's brother, Sean, was a quarterback at Virginia Tech, threw 23 touchdowns. Mike may pass that this season. He's got 20 already, including one this afternoon. The two met in the Virginia High School playoffs back in 2007. Game won by Glennon's team. He said Renner did a great job in the game, but he didn't have much of a defense.
No help. Well, this really has been a fun year in the ACC as far as young quarterbacks stepping in and playing at the high level. And you really got to consider Mike Glennett, even though he's a junior, one of the younger guys, just hadn't played very much. I mentioned only 10 games his first 2 years here at NC State. Obviously, Russell Wilson was here playing. Russell since has moved on, went for kind of pursued a baseball career, and ended up Wisconsin this year. And Mike has stepped in and really stepped in and done a nice job. A lot of these kids he's throwing the ball to are guys that he was throwing it to when he first got here. So
yards, this is total yards by down. Interesting statistic. NC State has really dialed it in defensively. Here's the pass. It's deflected. And it was hit. Renner was hit as he threw that football.
Look what happened on this. Yeah, I don't think it got hit, Mike, is what he was trying. Steve, he's trying to pull it back. He's trying to pull the ball back because he thought the outside receiver was going to run a hit trap. And when Boyd took off up the field, you see Boyd still running up the field at the top of your screen. He tried to pull the ball back, but at that point, it was too far through the throwing motion, so it just came out of his hand. He was going to throw the 6-yard hitch route to the outside, and it was not on the same page with Boyd.
C.J. Fiegel's, his kick almost blocked. And a flag down on the play. Brian Cheat almost got the ball.
Ball start. 57 to the kicking team. 5-yard penalty. Fourth down.
All season long, country music superstar Jason Aldean has opened up our ACC Network game with his hit single, My Kind of Party, from his album of the same name. Voting for the American Music Awards has begun. And Jason's up for Favorite Country Male Artist and Favorite Country Album. For details on how to vote, go to AMAvote.com. Voting ends next Friday, November 11th at midnight. Jay Graham back as C.J. Fiegel will be back to kick again. NC State feels they can get to the kicker. This time they don't, but Fiegel gets off a weak kick. Punting has been a problem for North Carolina this season. And he came in averaging about 38 yards a punt. This one won't even make that, 20 yards. And NC State gets the ball in good field position again.
Well, they've been in great shape all day long. North Carolina really should consider themselves lucky to only be down 10-0 as we close in on the end of the first half. But C.J. Fiegel's a struggle. Look at the first two punts were into the wind, getting a little bit of a break there. But the last two, and the wind is swirling some down in this stadium. But it's been tough for him to get the football.
Now, the wind is coming across the field, really. So it's going to bother everybody. Glennon scrambles out of the pocket, backs up, and lets one go at the sidelines. Pass intended over there for Jay Smith. Good pressure on the play by Sylvester Williams. Next week, we take you to Boston, 12 noon, for the ACC Blitz, brought to you by McAllister's, and then, of course, the game between NC State and Boston College. Always a spirited game. It's where Tom O'Brien used to coach before coming here. O'Brien, one of five coaches who've coached at two ACC postings. Jim Tatum, Bill Dooley, Al Groh, Bobby Ross, the other four. Here's Glennon. Hit by his own lineman. That pass intended there for Tobias Palmer. Going to be incomplete. Talk about NC State's defense, but North Carolina's defense has been pretty stout.
Well, what happens here is he gets some pressure and he slides up in the pocket. I don't think Mike Glennon gets enough credit for sliding around the pocket. He banged into one of his offensive linemen. Just a little too much heat on that throw to Palmer underneath. He needed to take a little bit off. He'd done a good job of freeing himself up. 6'6". You know, when you look at anything, well, this guy's not going to be able to move around very well. He really has a good pocket presence. He slides around and buys himself time.
Wolfpack 5-10 on third down. And looking at 3rd and 10 here. Glennon sprinting out, gives the pass fake and gets himself out of bounds. Zach Brown drove him out of there at about the 48-yard line. Game of two. Actually, they'll bring it back to about the 42. So that brings the punter on again. So defenses have dug in. Coming up at halftime, Danielle and Tommy have all the analysis, highlights, stats, and more, not only of this game, but the game going on in College Park between Maryland and Virginia. It's all coming your way on the Hyundai Halftime Report. Will Bauman ready to kick. Charles Brown back in return. The wrap on Brown is that he's been unable to catch the ball. He lets it come to him on the ground. He'll fair catch this one. It's a 45-yard punt. Brought down at the 10-yard line.
But we thought about Giovanni Bernard as the key part of this thing. In his first run right here, he creased the defense. But since then, it has been tough sledding for the redshirt freshman who came in averaging over 100 yards a game, 600-yard rushing days. But NC State has provided no room for him. 7 carries, only 13 yards for Giovanni Bernard.
1.9. Carry. Last year, NC State held North Carolina to just minus 7 yards rushing. Here's Brenner. Changes the play on 1st and 10 from his own 10. Play clock rolling down. Gets it away. Bernard squeezes out of there, out of the 10 to the 13. Audie Cole after a 4-yard gain.
tried one of their patented plays, broken line play, where they pull the backside guard and try. And Giovanni Bernard is so patient. He does a great job of getting in behind the block. But North Carolina is penetrating. As soon as they break the line of scrimmage with one of their guards, they get penetration. It's really knocking off the blocking assignments.
Second down and six. Renner to throw. Big pressure on. He didn't have a chance. And that is Brian Slay. Third sack of the day. The junior from Ashburn, Virginia, was there as soon as Renner pulled his arm up.
Well, Carl Gaskins, the senior, is playing in right tackle, and he just opens the door, and Slay runs right through it. And Gaskins actually pass set for the outside rusher. And when the outside rusher didn't come, he had no chance to get back to the inside to get Slay. Just opened the door, and Slay got it. That's the second time we've seen Slay in the backfield. Made a good play on a reverse play, and here he gets a sack.
Loss of nine on his third sack of the year. Third down. And long yardage for North Carolina. Renner throwing out of his own end zone. Now he'll come out with it, and he's thrown for a loss. Actually, he'll make no gain to the five-yard line. Art Norman is there.
Just a really good job of getting after the passes. Art Norman is a kid they're very excited about. Redshirt freshman. He shows up on film. Number 95 going to come right there and make the play. You watch Art Norman. He's got a spin move. He's got a power move. He's not real big yet. He's only 240 pounds. Just a redshirt freshman from Stone Mountain, Georgia. But when you watch the film, he's got a little Dwight Freeney in him. He's built a spin, get after the passer. They're excited about Utah.
Timeout on the field. Wolfpack up here 10-0. 2:10 left to go. Let's take a look at our BMW Ultimate Drive. It'll take you to their second possession of the game. Washington gets the handoff. After three handoffs, they go to Tobias Palmer. That sets him up inside.
And Tobias Palmer gets it on. This is the play action fake. Because they ran earlier in the drive, the play fake freezing the backers and the safety and over the top to T.J. Graham. That's your BMW Ultimate Drive.
Lennon making his 20th touchdown pass of the season. For T.J. Graham, it was his 14th overall touchdown and 5th touchdown reception. Ryan, let's go to the sidelines. For more on T.J. Graham, here's Scott Przewalski.
You know, T.J. Graham has scored that touchdown earlier. He's such a speed burner, and it's no reason why. It's easy to figure out. His dad, Trevor, was a member of the 4x400 relay team in the Seoul Olympics in 1998 for Jamaica. He's coached Justin Gatlin, Marion Jones. You better believe he learned how to run fast and run fast early in his life. He's back waiting to receive this punt right here, guys.
C.J. Fegels has had a struggle here today. The wind is kind of catty-corner off his left shoulder. And he'll get a low line drive that Graham will field and immediately be tackled, marking his progress to the North Carolina 45-yard line. Ryan Gupton on the tackle. It's a 40-yard punt. And no return yardage to speak of. And first and 10 at the 45 of North Carolina for the Wolfpack.
Well, I like that play by T.J. Graham right there. A lot of people say, hey, get away from the football. T.J. Graham has been returning punts at the highest level for a long time. And he realized he had a little Sunday hop there, so he caught it and really saved NC State probably 10 yards of field position there. So they scrimmage on North Carolina's side of the 50.
2:02 to go with one timeout. Pass is incomplete as Glennon tried to thread the needle there for Jay Smith. Trey Boston covered.
Poor decision that time by Glennon. He actually had George Bryan open. Watch 84, George Bryan open right there in the area, and he tries to force it up the field. George Bryan. And actually went back and had some words for his quarterback. Say, hey, get me the football.
Dana Bible said George Bryan wants to catch the football more than anything. A nice catch earlier where he extended for a first down. They could have used him there. The clock stopped at a minute 58. Second and 10. Here's Glennon. Thought about throwing the ball. Now throws it out while he was in the clutch. But he had two receivers there. Sylvester Williams. Junior college transfer.
Sylvester Williams comes from, you mentioned, the JC, Coffeyville Community College, or Junior College in Kansas. Good job of rushing the passer and getting after Glennon, forcing the errant throw. And North Carolina, their defense, really since that one drive that drive we showed you, the BMW Ultimate Drive, it really has settled in and have really defended their backyard, because that's where North Carolina State has been the entire game.
Glennon only two completions in his last 10 attempts. Back to throw again. This one to the sidelines. It is complete. But Palmer is brought down after only a two-yard gain. The clock continues to move as he stayed in bounds. NC State still has a timeout remaining.
Yeah, Everett Withers has got to be excited about how his defense has played. They really have done an outstanding job. I mentioned the fact that NC State has just been, this has been a 50-yard field for NC State. Everett Withers' defense has really bowed their back here in the first half.
Bauman is getting ready to kick it away. Charles Brown standing at his 10. Bauman. That's a good one off. Brown calls for the fair catch. The 6-yard line. It's going to be a 36-yard punt, no return. Stories around the ACC. Big night at Winston-Salem. Notre Dame starts its march through the ACC. 3 straight opponents. Wake tonight, Maryland, then Boston College. Wake's Morrell Noel and Matt Daniels of Duke, top 2 in NCAA passes defended in double digits. And of course, Virginia Tech's David Wilson. 8 100-yard outings this season. And how about Clemson, Sammy Watkins? Can we go through one of these without talking about him? No, we can't. Breaks ACC freshman records. And he's had a wonderful of success here. Now, Braden Hansen now is the new quarterback for North Carolina. And he's going to hand it off to Giovanni Bernard. Turns the corner and is brought down at the 10. About 3 on the play.
That's a dangerous tackle right there for Giovanni Bernard. And he's not feeling the effects of it. I thought that he came up a little bit gimpy on the play. He's kneeled down now. Terrell Manning, the great speed at linebacker, along with Dante Johnson. That time Dante Johnson pulling him to the ground. And we don't like the fact that he just, the tackle itself, because the body.
Bernard getting up slowly is. Art said, now Renner did not come out for that series. As we told you, Braden Hansen, a junior from Charlotte, North Carolina, Charlotte Latin High School, came out and took that snap.
Well, watch the tackle now, because the body of the defender is going to fall on Giovanni Bernard's left side. And as it turns out, his legs, he right there,
yep,
actually gets the right ankle caught up on the tackle by Johnson. And I think he started initially to try to walk it off, and it just didn't get any better for him, so he took a knee. So, boy, you talk about a guy they cannot afford to lose.
No, they really can't. He has had a tough day today, but credit the NC State defense. 9 carries, 21 yards. This is a guy who has 6 100-yard days and stands only 35 yards away from 1,000. You see Renner still standing on the sidelines. Ryan Houston now is in at the tailback spot, and this is Braden Hansen to throw. And the pass is incomplete. Overthrown for Jeremy Boyd. It stops the clock with 29 seconds. North Carolina has a timeout, but it doesn't seem like they're interested in prolonging this half any more than the 29 seconds we see here.
Well, throwing the football is not helping them any. They should have thrown the football right there if they wanted to try to run the clock out. That, they just did NC State a favor. North Carolina State sitting with 1 timeout left. They will burn the timeout here now if North Carolina runs the football and force North Carolina to try to punt it out of their own end zone. This is a big play here for North Carolina. They want to get out of here without having to punt it.
Tar Heels are 0 for 7 on third down here this afternoon. Hansen back to throw. Has some time. Has a man complete for the first down. And that is the most positive play of the afternoon. It's to Dwight Jones. It's 18 yards and it moves the chains.
This is a big throw by Hansen here. This comes in off the bench. Finds Dwight Jones over the middle. In zone coverage, what a big time throw that was.
It's the first earned first down of the day for the Tar Heels. Hansen sprints out of the pocket. 14 seconds left to go, and he's dropped at the 29-yard line by Terrell Manning. Gain of about 2, clock still moving. No attempt by North Carolina to stop it here at this point in time, and they will not. They'll head to the locker room. So the Tar Heels head to the locker room with a lot of questions to answer. NC State's got a lot of answers defensively this afternoon. They've pitched a shutout in just about every sense of the game. Let's go to the sideline. Scott Przewalski with Tom O'Brien.
Well, Coach, you have to be pleased with your defense, particularly against the running game for Carolina. What have you seen out there?
Well, I think our kids are excited to play this football game. They always have been. And certainly, I think coaches have got a good plan, game plan working right now. And we got a lot of football left to play, though, so we got to be ready to play this third quarter.
Yeah, you've got, this is a rivalry game. You know all about it. What do you say to these guys in the locker room about the second half?
Well, we're going to come out nothing to nothing. We got to kick off to them. They got first shot at us. We got to stop them. We got to win the third quarter.
Thanks so much, Coach.
Thank you.
Okay, that's head coach Tom O'Brien, his club leading North Carolina here in Raleigh 10 to nothing. Let's throw it over to our network studios in Charlotte. Danielle, it's all yours.
Thanks so much, Scotty P. Happy to have you here for the Hyundai Halftime Report. He's Tommy Bowden. I'm Danielle Trotta, and we are happy that we don't have to wait till the last week of the season for the interstate rivalry. You're watching North Carolina, NC State. Wolfpack obviously has the edge right now. Through two quarters, Coach, what stood out to you most?
Danielle, right now, North Carolina State's defense has only allowed one third down conversion for North Carolina. Right now, North Carolina has shot themselves in the foot. Big penalties has cost them points.
We saw their quarterback, Bryn Renner, not enter the final series of that second quarter. He was 5 for 12, 27 yards with an interception when he left the game. Tar Heels not having any offense to speak of. Points-wise on the board, we'll continue to break down the X and O's of this ball game, plus UVA Maryland coming up next. Your only touchdown score of the game, TJ Graham, his fifth of the season. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Hyundai Halftime Report from Charlotte, North Carolina, home of the Dr. Pepper ACC Championship game. Maybe getting a little ahead of ourselves. That's still 4 weeks away, but right here on week 10, an exciting ball game with UVA and Maryland, two teams who seem to be going in opposite directions. The Cavaliers only need one more win to become bowl eligible, while Maryland is hoping to snap a four-game losing streak at home. It's 14-13 UVA, halftime approaching, Coach. Let's get folks caught up. Perry Jones, you talked about the UVA running game. He gets them out 7-0.
Well, really did. This is something you can always hang your hat on, the running game. And again, is one that's easier to execute than the passing game, but something we talked about, and Virginia has done good.
Danny O'Brien starts for Maryland, but then C.J. Brown comes in, enters in the second quarter, breaks off the long run. He generates offense immediately for the Terrapins and converts. Devontae Campbell makes it 10-7. Maryland taking their first lead of the day. But UVA goes on top once again. The freshman back who can catch it too, Kevin Parks with the touchdown. Right now, UVA on top by one. 14-13, Coach. And how deflating would this be for Virginia to get a loss? They're coming off a win over Miami. They haven't been to a bowl game since the 2007 season. They are one game away. They can see it in their sights and trying to close on a Maryland team who has been very inconsistent.
Well, we talked last week a lot about the inconsistency of a team that Virginia needed to be consistent. A loss right there would really create some doubt and indecision in the player's mind. Coach London will have to resell them again on his philosophy.
A lot going on in that locker room then. Try to motivate his guys and get it done on the road. Speaking of, our Tommy Kane is always up and down the ACC, trying to have some fun wherever he goes. He's in Georgia Tech last week and having a little fun on homecoming weekend. It's a tradition, the tricycle race. If you want to see more, he's been skydiving, Coach, scuba diving. He had his shirt off. Bowden didn't like that so much. But the ladies here that watch the show may. Log on to theacc.com, powered by John Deere Gator XUV. It's acc.com/roadtrip. Still a lot more to come from Raleigh, North Carolina. We're getting you ready for the second half of the Heels versus the Wolfpack. That's coming up after the break. State on top 10-0. Geico presents the best of the ACC. Virginia Tech's David Wilson continues to lead the conference in rushing yards with an average of 132 per game. Wilson also leads the FBS in total rushing yards and is one of only six backs to have an eclipsed 1,000 rushing yard mark on the season. Through the air, Clemson's Sammy Watkins leads the ACC with over seven receptions per game with three left. All remaining freshmen have already set ACC freshman records for receptions, receiving yards, and receiving touchdowns. I'd say, yeah, that's the Geico's best of the ACC. Welcome back to the Hyundai Halftime Report. Speaking of Virginia Tech and Clemson, I'll throw Georgia Tech in there too. Three teams with open dates here on week 10. Here to break down the teams that are playing though, Coach Tommy Bowden, I'm Danielle Trotta. And Coach, Clemson, Virginia Tech, Georgia Tech in the driver's seat in the standings, but there's still some wiggle room as we head to the ACC championship game. Let's take a look at the belts, at the Belk, excuse me, standings.
Well, you'll see right here, Clemson, they'll be sitting around the TV tonight, eating their chicken wings and watching Wake Forest and see what happens in that game, because that's who they play next week. Then over in the Coastal Division, Virginia Tech, who will be watching, I'm sure, with interest of the Virginia game, because they've got them coming up later in the season. So the leaders will both be sitting back watching TV and seeing how the teams they play are going to operate today.
Virginia Tech, the defending ACC champions, see if they can get it done again in 2011. Still an unknown, but we do have ACC champions to crown in cross country on both the men and the women's side. Took place in Clemson, South Carolina not long ago. NC State brought home the men's title. It's the Wolfpack second in the past 3 years. Ryan Hill, your individual champion. Florida State wins the women's title, their fourth consecutive ACC cross country championship for the Lady Noles. Now, Coach Bowden likes to run, but I don't know if you could outdo these ladies.
I'm a barefoot jogger. They're wearing shoes. Not much of a challenge.
Coach likes to also run on the beach. A war of words that seems to be over. We're going to break down Withers and O'Brien's game plan coming up next. But first, a word from your local station. The ACC Digital Network and Haviland bring you highlights and insider analysis from every ACC football game. Get the latest coverage from around the conference straight to your laptop or your cell phone. Visit the ACCDN.com or search ACC in your mobile app store today. I'm just getting into the whole apps world, Coach. You're going to have to help me out here, but we're also getting into some great ball games here on the Hyundai Halftime Report from Charlotte, North Carolina. Coach, let's talk about North Carolina, NC State for just a bit. Some glaring stats overall. Most notably, UNC owned negative 11 rushing yards. We'll get to more X's and O's, but first, the war of words seems to have ended. Withers and O'Brien shaking hands before the game. And the home team strikes first. Mike Glennon finds TJ Graham his fifth TD of the year. Make it 7-0 State. NC State mixing up the run and the pass, but UNC struggling to generate with Bryn Renner, his first interception of the day, picked off by Earl Wolf, Coach.
Yeah, he saw the safety playing shallow and thought he could go over top, didn't get enough mustard on it, and that caused the interception.
This is tough for Tar Heel Nation, Coach. Just when you think you have some momentum, the flag is out and the touchdown called back.
This deflates you mentally as a team right there when you score, have to take points off the board.
NC State defense not taking their foot off the gas. There you saw Bryn Renner down. Coach, that was almost a safety. It's 10-0 State. And we have a Twitter question when it comes to this ball game. Do you think that having lost this interstate rivalry the past 4 years, it is now affecting the Tar Heels mentally?
Well, it'll affect them mentally, but it ought to be in a positive way. They might have a class of fifth-year seniors graduate and never beat NC State. That's the momentum I'm sure they had going into the game, but it has not helped them so far.
If you have a question for Coach Bowden, I'll help him answer it on Twitter. We're getting him adjusted to that world slowly. Our handle name is at the ACC Blitz. Coach, some numbers for this ball game looking at the second half. NC State has 130 total yards to UNC's 32. The Tar Heels also 11 negative yards rushing. Keys for the second half when you analyze those numbers.
Well, North Carolina right now can't shoot itself in the foot. Two key penalties, one cost them a touchdown, one a third yardage conversion that NC State got points off of. And then Mike Glennon has got to stay hot throwing and catching. TJ Graham needs to make a big play in the special teams.
You talk about Mike Glennon and the quarterback for NC State. Let's look at UNC's quarterback situation. Bryn Renner not in for the final drive in the second quarter. We saw the backup enter. Where do you go in the second half? Do you stick with the backup, or what do you do mentally to help Bryn Renner try to get some footing under him?
You know, sometimes when you bring in a young quarterback like this, the team can actually rally around him. They say, hey, we got to help him out. Everybody elevates their level of play one more notch. The offensive line, the wide receivers, the running backs could be a positive for North Carolina instead of a negative.
North Carolina not generating any score as of now. 10-0 NC State, but still two more quarters to go. Tom O'Brien wants to keep his team on top. They're 4-4 overall, trying to get above 500, while Everett Withers just trying to get some points on the board. His team 6-3 so far on the season. Enjoy the second half, folks. Coming up from Raleigh, North Carolina.
A great rivalry, and it's 101st showing, and it's been all defense in this first half. as North Carolina State leads here by a score of 10-0. Both teams have had a good accounting of themselves defensively, but especially NC State.
Yeah, they really have. I mean, this game has really been played in a 50-yard window to a certain extent. Steve, when you look at eight of the North Carolina State possessions of eight of them, three of them started in North Carolina territory. They really are lucky, and I'm talking about North Carolina now, they're lucky to be down 10-0.
Let's take a look at the stats brought to you by GMC, and there's not an awful lot to talk about both of these teams. Of course, total yardage, rush yards for North Carolina, they had only -7 last year. They're on target for that amount here this year. And what we don't show here, Dave, 15 plays by North Carolina of either 0 yards or less.
Unbelievable. 29 total plays in the first half, only 32 yards total for North Carolina, and 1 for 8 on third down. So that's John Shoup had to have gone in, put on the laboratory coat, and said, hey, we've got to figure something out. We got to do a new formula here for the second half.
And you look at the average starting position, it tells you, is watch two. Scott Przewanski standing by with North Carolina coach Everett Withers.
Well, Coach Gio Bernard, Brent Renner gets shaken up at the end of the first half. Will we see them and play the way they can play?
Well, we definitely will see Brent. We'll check and see if Gio can go. We expect him to.
Coach, I know you never want to be behind in a ball game, but do you feel fortunate to be down just 10 here?
Oh, there's no question. The defense has played excellent, and we just got to get our rhythm on offense. If we do that, we'll have a chance to be back in this ball game.
Okay, Coach, thanks so much. Right. Steve, back up top to you.
All right, thank you very much, Scott, for some good news there. As we heard Coach say, I'm Bryn Renner coming back, and Gio Bernard will test it out as well. Two keys that they will have for this second half if they're going to decide this comeback. They're down here 10-0. As we see Bryn Renner working out on the sidelines, got hit in that shoulder. ACC football is brought to you in high definition by H.H. Gregg. Larger selection, lower prices, smarter associates. H.H. Gregg, we help. North Carolina State will kick off to start the second half. North Carolina won the opening coin toss, deferred to the second half. T.J. Thorpe is the guy that the Tar Heels would like to have receive this football. Wide. It'll be Thorpe. Picks it up with a one. Thorpe, top kick returner in the ACC at 29 a carry. It gets it out to about the 21-yard line. It's a 21-yard gain. And Ryan Cheek on the down.
Talked about Giovanni Bernard and really what the non-factor he's been, and really credit to North Carolina State defense. They really got after the ground attack. And then right at the end of the first half, that tackle by Dante Johnson left Giovanni Bernard a little gimpy. And so they're going to retape the ankle. He's on the field, and he's going to give it a go.
Both he and Bryn Renner come back out after pausing at the end of the first half. And Bernard is stacked up right there by Marcus Kuhn, a graduate student from Germany.
The young quarterback for North Carolina, Renner, came in completing almost 73% of his passes. And you see, he's been rendered just, he has done nothing. 5 of 12, 27 yards, and he threw the one interception on an ill-advised throw down the field into the wind. So both Bernard and Renner are going to have to get it going for North Carolina.
Renner's been sacked 3 times today. Play action on first down. Passes complete to his tight end. That's Nelson Hurst. Plainfield, Indiana, transfer from Mississippi State, gain of 9.
Really a good catch by Nelson Hurst, too. Renner was way offline with this throw. But Nelson Hurst reaches out, makes a catch, and now you've got a third and short. And you could do something for only the second time in the game, and that's convert a third down. 1 for 8 on third down was North Carolina.
And Bryn Renner wasn't under center when that third down was converted. It was his backup, Braden Hansen. And off Bernard. And Bernard breaks through for the first down. And more as he gets it out over the 42-yard line. Tackled by Earl Wolf and Rashard Smith. It's a gain of 11.
Real nice sense of urgency here by North Carolina's offensive line. Again, the broken line play really match up well with the blocking, and then the patience of Giovanni Bernard. That time, no penetration. The North Carolina offensive line did a good job of limiting what NC State was able to do up front and create a nice running lane for Giovanni Bernard.
First and 10 for the Tar Heels, who trail by 10. Bernard cuts back against the grain, picks up a few blockers, but
An alert play by Emerson puts him down. The ball came loose. It's going to be North Carolina ball, but it's going to be a loss of one on the play.
Once again, a good job by NC State to cut down on Bernard's options of what he can do. This is a toss play. They want to go wide. Great job of penetration there. Cuts Bernard off. Now he has to go to the backside. And then David Emerson, a guy we haven't talked much about, leads the country in interceptions. Well, he shows he can tackle, too.
Not many thrown in his direction. Here comes the pass. It is going to be complete. And that's going to be Highsmith. Eric Mookie Highsmith for 14 yards.
It's a big time catch. Let's see if they keep Renner clean. Renner looks right now, throws back left, had Norman in his face. But what a catch by Highsmith. And those are the kind of plays, if you want to kickstart an offense, you have to make plays like that. The junior wide receiver made a huge catch for his quarterback.
First and 10. Three of the first four plays run by the Tar Heels in the second half have been for double-digit gains. And off Bernard. Cuts back. Carries Terrell Manning with him to the 42-yard line. Gain of four on the play.
North Carolina's offensive line, Steve, doing a much better job of coming off together and really getting shoulder to shoulder and not allowing an NC State player to penetrate here early in the third quarter. That time they provided the cutback lane for Bernard and picked up 3 yards.
Giovanni Bernard is now just a yard shy of 1,000 yards. It's been a tough day for him. Let's see if he gets it. Second down. Long count, pitch to Bernard. Turns the corner and gets 1,000 yards. The first 1,000-yard rusher in North Carolina history since 1997. And Jonathan Lynn.
Pitch to Bernard. Carries the football.
It's really impressive for the young kid to come in. Had a knee injury a year ago. Redshirted. Comes in as a redshirt freshman. Leads all freshman rushers in the country running the football now over 1,000 yards. Tremendous accomplishment for the young man.
Interim head coach Kevin Withers. Happy with what he's been able to contribute. And he's got to be happy with what his offensive unit's been able to do. Double tight end set now. Third down and two. Play action for Renner, who slips, fires just the same, and overthrows the intended receiver on the play. And that's going to be Jeremy Boyd.
Flag down in the secondary, which leads you to believe that there might be some pass interference or holding.
It's Jack Tabb, the true freshman. He was wide open.
Well, the play was set up to take a shot down the field. That's why they didn't throw it underneath. No eligible man downfield. That means one of the receivers that ended up being in the pattern was covered up by an outside receiver standing on the line of scrimmage. So an opportunity wasted there for North Carolina.
But they'll get another shot at third down. However, it won't be third and three. It'll be third and about eight. Drive started in North Carolina territory, and they're at the NC State 43. Eighth play of the drive, their longest possession of the afternoon. Renner, the big play coming up. There it is. It's to Dwight Jones, and it's going to be for the first down.
Good protection, just a zone coverage. And Dwight Jones, who's having a great year again this season, to the left of your screen, is going to come in into that zone area, just settle in that zone in front of Rashard Smith, the corner. Good job by Renner to get him the ball.
Sixth catch by Jones today. It's good for 15. Here's Renner. Back to throw, going for the end zone, and it is picked off by Emerson. He'll try to bring it out. Emerson, the nation's leader in interceptions, now has 9 on the season. And that's the second interception that NC State defense has turned into field position today. Wolf for the first one.
Again, this is a throw that looks like the wind holds the ball up because it's a play fake. They're going to take a shot. Christian Wilson, number 33, the wingback, going to release straight up the field and go to the corner. Now, if this ball's thrown to the back corner, he's got a chance. But see, again, underthrown. And then David Emerson, his 9th INT of the year, as you mentioned, Steve, leads the country He gets an outstanding return as he comes out of the end zone with it.
NC State has picked off 17 passes this season. Here's the handoff, goes to Washington on the quick change to the offense at the 33. There's no game. The Wolfpack have it. Renner now mulling his fate on the sidelines. Is that one hung up? You know, David, you talked about the wind. We've talked about it coming at about 15 to 17 miles an hour. That pass, the angle is right against the wind. And the exact angle that the wind's entering the stadium.
Well, and if you don't spin the ball, completely spin it, then it's going to get distorted in the wind.
Lennon blitz on, gets rid of it, pass to Palmer, complete. Palmer with more yards, first down and more. Palmer trying to sprint ahead of the field. He'll run out of steam and is brought down at the 13-yard line by Jonathan Smith. Huge play for the Wolfpack.
I'm not so sure Jay Smith didn't trip him on the play. The outside receiver, this is a really, they get a corner fire from Charles Brown. He's going to come into left of your screen now. The corner's going to blitz. You see him coming, number 12. Glennon shows the patience, waits, and finds Tobias Smith underneath on the little crosser. And now you see the great speed. Makes a defender miss there. And now let's see if Jay Smith doesn't trip him right here. Yeah, it looked like Jay Smith got his feet tangled up with his own player and tripped him up.
He's going over to try to throw a block there. And Palmer's still on the ground. We're going to take a timeout. We'll check on his status when we come back. NC State in the red zone again.
Today's telecast is being brought to you by BB&T, by Hardee's, by your local Toyota dealers, by AT&T, and by GEICO.
That's the trophy room at the Murphy Football Center here at Carter-Finley Stadium. NC State leading here 10-0. Tobias Palmer on the sidelines. He's okay after a 54-yard pass reception from Mike Glennon. We got flags here on first and 10. Looked like he landed on the football arc. You say that's happened to you a couple of times.
False start. 76 in the offense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Well, I think anybody that played any football in the backyard or anything, you get to running and the big brother tackles you and you think you're running for a touchdown, you land right square on the football in your stomach. You're fairly certain you're going to die at that point. He got no wind, and it certainly looked like that when he fell to the ground, the ball was kind of in that chest cavity area. And taking some deep breaths, but boy, he's come up big, dropped the first pass of the game, and since then, Tobias Palmer's been big time.
Had 5 receptions on the day. Here comes a handoff to Washington. That following the first NC State penalty of this game. That's a gain of 2. Kevin Reddick on the tackle for North Carolina. The Tar Heels were making good progress when Bren Renner threw it up for grabs, and it was intercepted by David Amerson, and he brought it back 32 yards, and then a 54-yard hookup from Mike Glennon upfield to Tobias Palmer. Brought them all the way to the 14. They're fighting to get their way back there now. They're at the 17-yard line of North Carolina. Glennon. Ball batted down. And that was Tydreek Powell.
Well, this is an active front four. We talked about it. When you can't get to the pass, you've got to get your hands in the air. Watch your right at you. Tydreek Powell elevates, bats the football down. This front four, it's so nice when you don't have to blitz to try to get to the passer. North Carolina, more often than not, does not have to bring more than just their front four to get pressure.
Powell says, I don't care if you're 6'6". This one's headed to the ground. Tobias Palmer's back in the ballgame now. He's in the slot to the near side of the field. Hand off Washington. Big hole. And Washington gets inside the 10 and down to the 7-yard line. Gene Robinson on the tackle. He's shy of the first down.
Well, you see how many Carolina defenders are in the hole. They were going to try to bail out and play coverage. And when they bailed out, it provided the crease for Washington to hit it straight ahead. And now they put it into where you got a chip shot field goal opportunity.
Fourth down coming, and Nicholas Sadie is in the ball game. He's already hit a 26-yarder. But Will Bauman's hold, and it's right down the middle of the field. This will be a 24-yarder. It is up, and it is good. So NC State cashes in on the turnover. Ryan and David Emerson's interception of Bryn Renner, they score on the 24-yard field goal. 13-0 Wolfpack over the Tar Heels. Fans are happy. They'd like to see a fifth straight win over the Tar Heels. Right now, in good shape for that 24-yard field goal. Nicholas Sadie. Sadie's getting ready to kick off. T.J. Thorpe getting ready to return. 7:29 left to go. David Amerson's interception set up the field goal scoring drive. Here comes the return. And it's right at the wedge. Sean Tapley standing to the left. Bryn Renner today got it rolling in that last possession, but it's been a tough afternoon.
Well, it's been a brutal afternoon for the sophomore quarterback. He has taken some heavy hits. He's been batted around. This hit right here left his shoulder aching. And his last throw, this one, left his head aching. As Anderson picked him off and set up what ended up being a 3 points for NC State. But Renner has had a tough, tough day. See, almost 73% of his passes coming in. Struggled today for North Carolina.
Best field position of the day for Bernard's first rush. He crossed the 1,000-yard threshold in the last series. He has five more for 1,009 unofficially, to the 49-yard line. Tar Heels came out here in the second half, moving the ball a lot better. And of course, the big interception, second thrown today by Bryn Renner. What can you say about this NC State defense? Mike Archer has called a marvelous game here this afternoon for the Wolfpack. Bernard. A pocket tackle made by T.Y. McGill to slow him down. A 2-yard gain.
Well, again, Steve, it's the penetration in front. This time, T.Y. McGill, number 75, the freshman from Jessup, Georgia. A great job of penetrating. And now North Carolina faced with another third down conversion situation.
There's Mike Archer. And save him midway. He's got a partner in kind up in the booth in John Tenuta. Together, they've dialed up this defensive mix. Third down coming now for the Tar Heels. We trail here 13-0. And now we've got to wait, and it looks like it's going to be a timeout. North Carolina has to call it here. And we're going to take it with them. 6:09 left to go in this third quarter of play. NC State 13-0. Back after this message from your local ACC station.
Here with a Hardee's update. UVA going for it. Fourth and goal from the one. Perry Jones scoots in. Touchdown, Hoos. 21-13 UVA over Maryland.
Virginia becomes bowl eligible with a win in that game this afternoon. They become the sixth ACC team to bowl eligibility. Ryan Houston's in the backfield now on third down and four. North Carolina down 13. Leonard, pass complete. It's to Wilson. And Christian Wilson takes it down to the NC State 33-yard line. Earl Wolf on the tackle, but not before he's got 17 yards.
You look at the left-hand side of your screen. There's where the pressure comes, and then here comes the back on the back. Oh, there, Christian out of the backfield makes the catch. Well, Christian Wilson, I'm sorry.
Reach back, coming out of there with Curtis Byrd. He's back in the lineup today. Here comes Ryan Houston. The hard-charging fifth-year senior from Charlotte, North Carolina, gets a 2-yard gain. Brandon Bishop got the tackle. As far as North Carolina is concerned, first eight drives in the first half. 29 plays, 32 yards. It's gone much better for them in the second half. They still don't have any points to show for it. 13 plays, 70 yards. They're looking at second and eight. Bernard back in.
Played much better up front here in the second half so far.
Bernard. And brought down from behind there by Norman. Art Norman. Nice stop.
And I like this kid. I saw him on film. Really shows up. He's a guy that plays with a lot of effort. His motor is always running. And here he flows from the backside. He's got really good speed. He'll get bigger. He only weighs about 240 pounds right now. But I mentioned Dwight Freeney
defensive end for Indianapolis Colts, undersized guy that has great speed to the football.
North Carolina's hit their last four third down conversions. They're 4 for 11 in the game. Renner back to throw, not going to hit this one as he's going to be sacked. And it's a one-man show by Terrell Manning. That's the fourth sack of the day for the Wolfpack defense.
That's a great job by Manning to make the play, but he really doesn't help out. Look, Bond's going to try it out. 76 going to try to step out. But the pressure from the backside forced Renner into Manning, so Bond could not make the block for him. Just a lot of people getting into the backfield and disrupting things for NC State.
C.J. Fiegels is on. And a busy day for him, not necessarily a productive one. Graham back at his 10. Almost got to a couple of punts. Looking for a lot of yards here, and Graham fumbles the football. Luckily, it goes out of bounds. Wow, very, very close. A 38-yard kick, and it was nearly recovered by the Tar Heels. Gupton was right there.
Good job by C.J. Fiegels to push it into the corner. That's what they're trying to do, is punt it outside the numbers. Made Graham go a long way to catch the football. So a good job by C.J. Fiegels. Struggled a bit in the first half. That was an outstanding punt outside the numbers. And really made it tough on Graham to get there, and it almost resulted in a turnover.
Well, they know what Graham can do to them. 87-yard punt return last year. And now the Wolfpack will be faced with their worst start of the afternoon, their own 6-yard line. And it may not have been a start at all, and North Carolina's Brian Gupton been able to get there. Pass is incomplete, intended for George Bryant. ACC fans, AT&T wants to give you the chance to take your team to the top of the buzz rankings. Visit buzzrankings.com to find out how to make your team's social media buzz climb. The Miami Hurricanes currently lead the way among ACC schools, so start creating buzz for your school now. Buzz rankings are brought to you by AT&T, the exclusive wireless partner of the Atlantic Coast Conference. Got a flag down. It looks like it's going to be an illegal
receiver. Second down.
Eligible man downfield for North Carolina State.
Down over again, the second time we've had that. It's going to be half the distance, puts it back to the 3. So this is the biggest hole that Mike Glennon has had to bring the Wolfpack offense out of here today. Underwood comes and splits right out in front of the couch. Glennon, the throw, ball is deflected. And it's Dante Page Moss, junior from Jacksonville, North Carolina, with the deflection. Brings up second down.
They've really done a good job of schooling these defensive linemen. If it's a short rush to get or a short drop by the quarterback, get your hands in the air. We've seen them bat a number of footballs. That time Paige Moss gets the knockdown. We see Bryn Renner returning to the locker room. Not a good sign for North Carolina. That means Braden Hanson will take over quarterback.
North Carolina's defense is successful in none too short order. Here's Washington. He pushes it out to about the 5-yard line with more on Bryn Renner. Here's Scott Przewanski.
Yeah, we saw Renner go into the locker room. It's his left side of his body. It's up around his shoulder area. Same area he got hurt on a sack towards the end of the first half. He got sacked, as we saw in that last series. So he's into the locker room and saw his backup, Braden Hanson. He's on the sidelines, obviously, right now warming up.
Now NC State is 5 of 13 on third down. They've missed the last 4 in a row, so Braden Hanson may be into this battle before very long. Washington breaks it around the corner. Heads down to the 30, about the 29-yard line, and Gene Robinson is there to make the stop on one of the most successful running plays of the day for State.
North Carolina State has made a habit of running the ball on third down, and it's man coverage in the secondary. So if you don't get him sealed in on the edge, then Washington's going to find room because the defenders are running man coverage with the receivers. They got the edge sealed, and Washington got up the sideline. Big first down pickup for NC State.
19 yards, Arch. Here we go. First and 10. Washington deals his way ahead for another 4 yards. Tackle on the play by Tyreek Powell. Wolfpack start moving just when they feel they need to.
You really got to give big guys up front for North Carolina State a lot of credit. This is a defensive line that's highly regarded by many across the country as one of the better groups. But their offensive line, led by Camden Wentz, their center, number 53, have really done a great job of coming off the ball and providing a run game for them.
Second down. Here comes Washington again. This time a hole closes off quickly at the 36-yard line. And once again, Tyreek Powell on the tackle for the Tar Heels after the gain of two. 13-0 our score. Two Nicholas Sadie field goals following a T.J. Graham touchdown reception of 12 yards from Mike Lennon. What stand on the scoreboard right now? Tony Creasy is in the backfield now on third down and four. Glennon to throw. Pass is complete. And it's Jay Smith with the catch, moves the chains to the 43-yard line. It's an 8-yard gain.
Because you stay in manageable third down situations, you can run the little flat slant combination. It's just giving you a quick catch, one in the flat, one on the slant, and an excellent catch by Jay Smith. Watch, you get a plant come inside. Defender falls. Tobias Palmer outside on the flat route. Slant area is open in that little window. And an excellent catch by Jay Smith, extended route.
First and 10. Ball at the 44. Glennon wants his receiver to go downfield, but it was Howard out there, and he seemed to get pinned along the North Carolina sideline.
He allowed himself to get pushed out of bounds, and then he didn't come back in. Glennon actually escaped the pass rush, and then Howard re-entered the field and run down the sideline. He had a chance because he was forced out of bounds, but he kind of quit on the play, and so Glennon had to throw the football away.
So brings up second down. Wolfpack trying to climb back into this Atlantic Division race. Tony Creasy is in the backfield now. State 1-3 in ACC play. Creasy, redshirt freshman out of Durham, North Carolina. He's tackled by Zach Brown and Trey Boston after a 4-yard gain.
Zach Brown, number 72. Zach Brown, number 47. Zach Allen, number 72, had a good block on that play. But Zach Brown, the linebacker, we talk about him all day long. Just an outstanding football player. Does a great job of running the ball.
Six tackles today and 9 a week ago against Wake Forest. You go with a fumble recovery and an interception. Third down, 6. Pass through the hands of Tobias Palmer. Dangerously hung out there, and it's going to be fourth down.
Yeah, just mentioned Zach Brown, and here he comes on the pressure right through the middle, number 47. Don't block him, and if there's anybody you want to get blocked, that's that guy right there. Number 47 forced a quick throw. Really did not allow anything to set up.
And like Audie Cole, he's a Butkus semifinalist.
Yeah, you'll see that guy playing on Sundays for a long time.
He got disciplined and played only special teams against Georgia Tech. He has been a monster all season long. Bauman's kick is going to be fielded by Charles Brown, a 46-yard punt. And no return. Ram Trucks presents the Ram Power Play. Georgia Tech spoiled Clemson's quest for an undefeated season last Saturday with power plays like this. Lewis Young, Rod Sweeting with a big hit on DJ Howard, who fumbled the ball. That hit would lead eventually to an Orwin Smith touchdown run that started a 24-0 run by the Yellow Jackets on the way to the win. The Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets with this week's Ram Power Play.
Well, you can't give Al Groh enough credit for the defensive effort that they had that day. Jamia Thomas, the corner, has two interceptions, makes a great play right after Georgia Tech had turned the ball over. Give Al Groh a lot of credit for the defensive game plan.
Last play of the third quarter, Brayton Hansen passes complete to Dwight Jones. Dwight Jones fall ahead for some extra yardage here. Still going to be shy. 5-yard gain. And that'll pretty much do it for the third quarter of play. Rashard Smith comes up with a tackle, but the Tar Heels have a long way to go. They're down 13. A lot of distance to make up on a hostile field if they want to avoid losing their fifth straight to the Wolfpack. NC State with 3, a 13-0.
In this Hardee's update, fear mounting for the Turtles. Rodney McLeod intercepts the pass for Danny O'Brien. Been a tough few weeks for the QB. UVA converts on the Max Million touchdown. 28-13, Cavaliers in control.
I don't think anybody thought that Virginia would come away with six wins this season. Braden Hansen fumbled the snap from center and was lucky to get that thing out of there and off to the sideline.
Well, actually, he went down to a knee to pick up the ball, and they called him down. So they lose about 3 yards on the play.
Back to the 9-yard line. Our stats for three quarters brought to you by Home Depot. That rush yardage total, that's not a misprint. Three. North Carolina State is 103. Third down conversions, NC State at 7 of 16. All of those first downs for North Carolina, 8 of 7 of the 8 have come in the second half. They need one here. They're looking at third down and 8. Braden Hansen in the lead from Bryn Renner. Pass is complete. No, it's dropped. Good coverage on the play intended for Highsmith. Manning is there. Carolina last year held only 7 yards, minus 7 rushing. They were sacked 7 times. They've been sacked so far this afternoon 4 times. 411 passing yards in that game, the third most last season. They're nowhere near that this afternoon. And C.J. Feagles has to punt this one out of his end zone. Feagles the man this afternoon. As Everett Withers has looked to reinvigorate his punt game, and this one's going to take a nice bounce from North Carolina down to about the North Carolina State 39-yard line. It's a 53-yard kick with no return. The ACC Digital Network has arrived each week. ACC alums Dorsey Levins and Riley Skinner join host Kyle Montgomery to deliver insider's coverage from around the ACC straight to your laptop or mobile device. Visit the ACCDN.com or search ACC on your mobile app store today. ACC Digital Network, access anytime, anywhere. Tony Creasy in the backfield now for North Carolina State. Here's the handoff, and he is slowed by Kevin Riddick. Finally brought down there by Lipford. And no gain on the play. For NC State, now the clock in their favor. They're up 13, Arch. Clock seems to move. They don't seem to be in a hurry to do things. Get some stuff on the ground, though.
Yeah, they're trying to pound out a little ground attack. Good play by Reddick to come in and limit that to less than a yard gain, and really going to have to force Glennon to throw the football. But North Carolina's defense has really held up their end of the bargain.
Glennon pass is complete. And that's Brian Underwood, the redshirt freshman, tackled by Zach Brown. It's a gain of 8. Parents, register your child today for the ACC Kids Club. Children 8th grade and younger will enjoy outstanding benefits, including a chance to win a pair of tickets to the ACC Football Championship in Charlotte. Visit acckidsclub.com to register your child now.
And North Carolina State in this area has been very comfortable running the football. I think that North Carolina is trying to force them out of that.
Here comes the run by Creasy. And he's going to be very close to the first down. Robinson in Boston, the nickelback, come in and make the stop.
And they needed to reach the 48-yard line. But see, North Carolina crowding the line of scrimmage, and really they run by the play. Good running by Creasy to bounce it just a hole wider, and then good physical finish at the end. And it looks like he's right on the tape.
We're going to have to measure this thing. Let's go to the sidelines. And Scott Przybylski has the latest on Bryn Renner.
Yeah, Bryn Renner is done for the remainder of the ball game. He's back in the locker room with concussion-like symptoms, so he's not going to play the remainder of the game. You know, at halftime, we said it was his shoulder. He was banged up there, but they also evaluated them as well because he's really been knocked around quite a bit. They felt like he could come back in the second half, but after this last blow, they feel like just too tight a call, and so he's not going to play.
Yeah, this is close.
What, did he get out his credit card?
I'm telling you.
Determine whether it's breaking the line.
Tom Zamorski said it's a little more than a swipe. And it's going to be fourth down.
Well, it looked like Tom O'Brien on the sideline says, hey, wait a minute, you're tilting the standard towards North Carolina's side. That's why it didn't match up. But, you know, Tom O'Brien, I like what he's doing. Looks like he's going to keep his offense on the football field here and go for it.
Really, North Carolina has not been able to stop them in short yardage situations running the ball. So, a bit of a gamble here, but I think he realizes that it's an opportunity for Will to take a lot of time off the clock.
Now, a little extra time to think this over as the play is going to be under review. And as they review this play, we're going to take a break with them here. 12:39 left to go in the fourth quarter. NC State with the ball up 13. ACC football is brought to you by Havoline, by your local Toyota dealers, by GEICO, and by your Carolina Ford dealers. On the campus of NC State University on a Saturday afternoon, and the replay confirmed that it is going to be fourth and inches, or an inch, if that, for NC State. Big fourth down play here going for it. Glennon pushes ahead. You ask for an inch, I'll give you 6 feet and 6 inches of Mike Glennon.
I like the decision to go there. I just think that I think Tom O'Brien's staying there, trying to just make sure that he seals this game with his offense on the field. I think the defense has played extremely well, but he senses North Carolina moving it at the end to move it a little bit. And Glennon, as you mentioned, Steve, at 6'6", 230 pounds, leans forward and gets the first down. Really, the best friend of a quarterback in that scenario is the center. Cameron Wentz got just enough movement, because at 6'6", you're a big target.
All you got to do is stretch. You get to the center shoulder pads, you should be in good shape.
Just get in behind big number 53 and let him lead you to the promised land.
Graham is split wide out to the top, first and 10. And off goes to Creasy. He's close to midfield. Expect the Tar Heels to be pulling at the ball here as time starts to roll through, and they're down two scores.
I think North Carolina has got, or North Carolina State has the Tar Heels in a position right here where play action, they could get one of their speedy receivers one-on-one deep. I think the North Carolina is really trying to sell out to stop the run game.
Second down at 8. Since the ACC started up, this series has been fairly even. North Carolina has the edge there, 32-26. But overall, 63-31-6. However, they've lost the last four to the Wolfpack. And off PC, not much. Maybe to the 48. Sylvester Williams in on the tackle. Hey, fans, CPI Security is giving away 4 tickets to the ACC Football Championship game. To enter, visit cpisecurity.com/ACC. Ticket buying keeps going. CPI may be the only people holding on to tickets right now. There's a brisk 10 days of ticket sales in Charlotte for that ACC Championship game. Who will play in it?
We've got a huge game next Thursday night between Virginia Tech and Georgia Tech, which will go a long way to determine who's probably going to play Clemson in the ACC Championship game. Obviously, a few more stumbling blocks for Clemson to get over to represent the Atlantic, but the Coastal still very much up for grabs.
Oak Forest is standing in their way down the line. NC State is as well. Here comes Glennon. One up over the top, and this one will be behind his receiver intended that time, C.J. Graham. Jay Smith also in the vicinity, so Wolfpack will end up punting with the left field position. They get a chance to flip it here. They'll be punting from the 49-yard line. Next week, Wolfpack go to Boston College to take on the Eagles. Tom O'Brien returns to the spot where he coached 10 years, built that program to prominence. See it beginning with the ACC Blitz, brought to you by McAllister's Deli. Here on the ACC Network. Oh, he'll go after that punt. They nearly get it. Here's Charles Brown trying to dig his way out of the 15-yard line. Gets out to the 18. And that's where it'll be first and 10. And now we've got some extracurricular activity, as one would expect. Got a flag down on the field after the play was over.
I think Mario Carter, tight end, one of the extra tight ends. He was got him to mix up a couple plays ago, and I don't think he had it all out of his system yet.
See by the referee's jerseys the wind that you have to contend with down there. See what happens at the end of this play. Right down.
After the play, personal foul.
87 North Carolina State. After the play, dead ball, personal foul. 57 North Carolina. Fouls offset. First down.
Lots of emotion in this series. A lot of emotion on the field this afternoon. But the scoring belongs to NC State. 10.5 to play, and the Wolfpack up 13. You're watching the ACC Network, an exclusive production of Raycom Sports. Carter-Finley Stadium, nearly 58,000 strong, and a lot of them in Wolfpack red. They like what they see. The defense on the field, and it's first and 10. Braden Hansen gonna control this from here on out. He gets rid of it to Bernard. And Bernard gets the first down and moves the ball up over the 41-yard line. We have a flag, however, in the North Carolina backfield. It's a 23-yard gain conditional. It looks like it's going to be marked off against NC State.
A rough at the passer on North Carolina State. Looks like that T.Y. McGill, freshman, had gotten in on Hanson. McGill coming in and... Giovanni Bernard, we talk about his running prowess. He's a great receiver coming out of the backfield. Nice job of setting up the screen there.
Home last drive.
I'm not sure about that as far as the roughing the passer call, but you're supposed to stay off of him as much as you can, I guess.
24 yards in the game and an additional 15 yards for the penalty in Wolfpack territory now for North Carolina. Braden Hansen at the controls. Here's Bernard, not much running room there. This Wolfpack defense has been outstanding all afternoon.
See, this is a North Carolina offense that had 500 yards of offense a week ago against a really good Wake Forest team. But this North Carolina defense, North Carolina State defense, has been all over the place. 122 yards of total offense today for North Carolina. Phenomenal.
25 plays with zero or minus yards. Hansen, the throw is complete. This is Christian Wilson out of the H-back spot, and he'll get to the 30-yard line. Nice gain on the play. Maddox and Bishop bring him down, but it's a 13-yard gain. You know, we talked about those 120-plus yards or so. Most of them have come here in the second half.
Yeah, just 32 yards of offense in the first half on 29 plays. They've obviously picked up the slack a little bit, but still, North Carolina State's defense has been the defense that we saw last year. They were very good a year ago.
9 minutes to go. Houston in the ball game for Giovanni Bernard, and the pass is complete. It's going to be to Dwight Jones. He had a long 75-yarder for a touchdown, called back on a hold in the first half. Otherwise, he struggled to pick up yardage. He's got 7 catches.
You've got to be impressed the way Braden Hansen has come in and taken control of this offense. This is a guy coming into today, it was 1-for-2 on the season. And he didn't play at all in 2010. He looks very comfortable in the game right now.
And he's got good size. He's 6'6". He's 5-for-7 so far this afternoon since coming in for Renner. Look at that second down. Two-step drop, the pass. No. Intended for Hurst. Nelson Hurst is tied in. Couldn't get the handle on it.
That's an area, Steve, that has really hurt North Carolina. They have not been able to get consistent play from a pass receiver standpoint at the tight end spot. Remember, Zach Pianalto, Ryan Taylor, the two tight ends that moved on and are in the National Football League or on rosters. 66 receptions between those two gentlemen a year ago on a tight end. They just have not gotten that consistency of tight end this year.
Third down coming up and 6. North Carolina 4-13. This is one of their biggest that they've faced. Hansen with a high snap and the draw to Houston. Houston ahead, and he's going to be short. Game of only 2. Terrell Manning makes the huge stop. And it brings up 4th down.
These two linebackers that we talked about off the top. Audie Cole, number 42, right here. He's going to play the edge, going to take away the edge. Spins back to the inside. And then Terrell Manning coming off the backside. Those two linebackers really created problems for Everett Withers' offense.
Tar Heels will go for it on 4th down. 4th and about 3. Houston is the power back. Hanson, the look, pass broken up. Intended for Dwight Jones, and Manning got in front of him for the second time today.
Boy, you talk about an instinctual play here from a linebacker that's been huge all day long. Terrell Manning, he initially was up in the line of scrimmage, and he's reading the quarterback's eyes, and he goes and finds it and bats it away. NC State still leads.
Update, we have kickoff. Duke at Miami, first quarter, opening drive. You see the long screen by Mike James. Great field position for the home team. Sets up a one-yard TD pass. 7-0 Miami. P.S. It's 31-13. UVA pulling away from Maryland.
And Virginia closing in on their sixth win of the season. Ready to go. This is James Washington in our game. It's 13-0. NC State leading North Carolina. McAllister's Deli giving two lucky guests each a Jeep Wrangler. Register at Facebook.com/TFreaks for official rules, entry form, great weekly tailgate prizes. That's Facebook.com/TFreaks, and you could be a winner of a sweet ride. Two of those going out. Went up on second down now here for the Wolfpack. Up here 13-0. Clock rolling on their side with 7:09 to go. Glennon out there in the flats, complete. That's Howard or Jay Smith. Jay Smith, fifth-year senior from Norfolk, Virginia. Maybe close to the first down. A couple more first downs, and Wolfpack may get their fifth straight.
Yeah, the numbers aren't great for Glennon, but his third pass was picked off of the game. He's had a couple balls dropped in the game, but really he's done a good job of taking care of the football, which is really what he's done all year long. He came in with 8 interceptions through his 9th today, but he also threw his 20th touchdown pass for Tom O'Brien. And Tom's really been pleased with the way this guy's progressed. Remember, they hadn't played a lot coming into this season.
3rd and 3, pass is complete. And coming up with it is going to be Jay Smith. Moves the first down marker out to about the 36-yard line, a 7-yard gain.
NC State's gotten a lot of mileage out of this slant-flat combination. This time, Jay Smith in the flat, and he had a slant running over the top of him. So they've done a good job of running that combination, and they've converted 2 or 3 first downs with those short throws.
Clock moving, 6 to go. Washington is the setback behind Mike Leonard. Washington, upended there by Reddick and Powell, gain of about 3. Brings up 2nd down and 7. Closed captioning for ACC football is brought to you by Bojangles' famous chicken and biscuits. It's bow time. As time winds down here, Wolfpack, offense on the field, their defense trying to take credit for first shutout in this series since 1960 and the first shutout in Raleigh since 1921. Glennon, pass is complete, but the back arrived there. That was Scotland, a nice tackle on the pass out there to Jay Smith.
They really could take a shot down the field if they wanted to. North Carolina's jumping everything. If you fake this throw right here to the flat and then turn the slot receiver up the sideline, there's nobody home for North Carolina.
Timeout on the field, and we're going to take it with them. Timeout on the field, 13-0. North Carolina State back after this from your local station. I'm not sure these two guys will be exchanging Christmas cards after all that happened this week, but they coached their teams to a spirited game here this afternoon. Tom O'Brien on the right sees his team leading. Interim head coach Everett Withers. Been a tough situation for him. Took over 6 days before preseason started. North Carolina fired Brooks Davis. 3rd down. NC State. The pass is complete, but it looks like it's going to be shy of the first down. This is to Stephen Howard, 5th-year senior out of Charlotte. It's an 8-yard gain. Trey Boston on the stop.
That's a pretty good moment before the game between Everett Withers and Tom O'Brien as the two teams came out on the field and were warming up. Those two got together about midfield, and there was an exchange of handshakes, and they actually spent some time talking there for a few moments. It wasn't one of these brush-by handshakes. They actually had a moment there where they had a chance to speak and stuff. And just like players, or you get caught up in the heat of the battle trying to defend your school. Obviously, Everett Withers feels very strongly about North Carolina and the direction they're headed. Obviously, they've had to weather the storm over the last 18 months, but he's very passionate about what they've got going in Chapel Hill. And Tom O'Brien, obviously the Marine, he's not going to back down off of what he feels like he's got going here at North Carolina State. So, two guys very passionate about both programs.
They both have to sit here and recruit against each other and oftentimes follow each other into the same household. That's not easy. The official ACC mobile apps are now available for you on iPhone, iPad, and Android. You'll get live streaming of all ACC Network football telecasts, along with live stats from all conference games, video features, breaking news, and score alerts. Download today by visiting theacc.com/apps. Steve Martin here along with Dave Archer and Scott Przewanski. Our producer is Rob Reichert, our director Lonnie Dale. Of course, up here in the booth, Freddie Kygron stats. Ken Trevor's our spotter here this afternoon. Greg Murray, our stage manager. Thanks to all. Fourth down coming up here for the Wolfpack.
Really no decision to be made here. It's fourth and about a yard and a half. And this is a punting situation for North Carolina State. They went for it earlier, but it was about the length of the football. The biggest thing they have to guard against here is the double thud. They cannot have, if you're North Carolina State, you cannot allow a block kick here. North Carolina has been very close to blocking a kick.
Both teams have had near success there today, and this is going to be Will Bauman, the freshman, a true freshman from Wilmington. And again, he just got that one away. Brown with a fair catch. Puts it up at the 24-yard line. 36-yard punt and no return. That's where the Tar Heels will pick it up. Check out the new team pages section of the ACC.com brought to you by Toyota. You'll find exclusive video and features on your favorite team from the ACC Digital Network. Access anytime, anywhere. ACC Digital Network launched about 3 weeks ago, and look at that. On the season, 160.6. Today, only three. Last year, minus seven.
The NC State defense had been giving up 160 on the ground, and so they really came into this game feeling the weight of the rivalry and have stepped up big time.
Hanson on in relief of Bryn Renner, who injured his shoulder and will not return. The pass is complete to Dwight Jones. Dwight's had a big day in terms of receptions. North Carolina, that's the ninth reception for Dwight Jones. They're looking for the first two, a pair of receiver and a running back with 1,000 yards and closing in on it. Let's go to the side. Scott Przewanski.
Well, guys, no secret this NC State defense has just been backed up throughout the course of the season, but a lot of credit's got to go to Mike Archer. He loves to blitz, and you touched on it earlier. He's got a great relationship with John Tenuta, and if Tenuta up in the box gives him a call, he doesn't even question about it because he respects him so much. They've got a strong relationship, and it's really showing with this State defense today.
Pass to Ebron. Is it complete? John Tenuta is known as a, and he's been defensive coordinator at places in the past. They wondered if this combination would work, but Mike Archer told us yesterday it's working swimmingly. He finds that the two of them are on the same wavelength all the time. And it certainly has paid off today. They haven't made many mistakes, if any. Here comes Hanson. Pass is complete. Hanson's looked pretty good here, Archer, this afternoon, to pass to Heitzman.
I just think that he's comfortable. He's been and for a guy that hasn't played very much, he just looks very comfortable back there. This is an NC State team that has harassed North Carolina all day long. He just looks very comfortable back there slinging the ball around.
Here comes pretty high heat and an interception.
I jinxed him.
And that is Cato Bishop on the interception. The deflection, though, was J.R. Sweezy, fifth-year senior from Mooresville, North Carolina.
Well, Cato Bishop has played D-tackle and defensive end for this team. You get the pressure from the inside from Sweezy. Really probably an ill-advised throw from from Braden Hansen trying to throw the ball away. And see how athletic these great big guys are. Cato Bishop, 6'4", 285 pounds, squeezes it. And maybe the final nail in the North Carolina coffin today.
Second interception, third interception by the Wolfpack, the fourth interception of this game. North Carolina had one in the first quarter. Somebody got a birthday wish today. 3 minutes and 36 seconds of closing this out. And only the third shutout in this series since 1921. There's a flag on the play.
Tom O'Brien a little upset. Felt like the play clock had started a little bit early. He just didn't get his offense on the field with the delay game. We'll wave it off.
There's no foul on the play. NC State called for timeout before the clock expired.
There it is. Tom Zamorski working this game as referee. As Tom O'Brien talks it over with his team. Next Saturday, the ACC Network heads to Chestnut Hill as North Carolina State takes on Boston College. Wolfpack will have to contend with the Eagles' Deuce Finch. Rolando Flint Finch, who had a career day a week ago, ran for 243 yards and a pair of touchdowns in the BC win against Maryland. Visit the ACCNetwork.com for more information on how you can watch the ACC Network Game of the Week on TV, online, and on the official ACC mobile app. And that's what NC State has left. Now they'll have to win two of those next three to become bowl eligible. Boston College on the road, and then they'll close at home with number 11 Clemson and Maryland. All not only ACC games, but Atlantic Division games. And as far as North Carolina is concerned, they're coming up on their first off date of the season, and then the big showdown at Virginia Tech. And then they close the regular season with a traditional rivalry against Duke, and that'll be at Chapel Hill. That Virginia Tech game is huge. Virginia Tech playing two Thursday games in a row. Georgia Tech and North Carolina. Right off to Washington. All the Wolfpack has to do here now is roll the clock down.
You just have to be impressed the way North Carolina State has come out and made a commitment to the running game. Credit the offensive line for really bowing their back against a really good defensive front at North Carolina, because they provided enough of a spark running the football that James Washington is over 100 yards rushing.
Great day for him and the Wolfpack. 4.4. And that has helped Mike Glennon out, too. Especially, it helped set up the game's only touchdown. Under three to play. Second down. All kinds of movement here. Tydrick Powell might have gotten across the line a little early. ACC race. Florida State now getting back into it now as they're getting healthy. Got a chance to run the ball a little bit more.
Offsides by contact against the defense. Penalty yards.
We really have to be impressed with what Mike London's doing at UVA.
Oh, yeah.
In Virginia, going on the road, beating Miami in Miami, and of course really winning resoundingly today against Maryland on the road. And that's one of the toughest things to get your team to do, is to win on the road. I don't care what conference you're in, but certainly in the ACC, very difficult to go on the road and win. Mike London has won a couple of big road games, and he really has that ship going in the right direction. I'm impressed with what he's done.
And off here. And it's going to be Washington again. Another flag on the play here as this game winds down. It's a little nasty. It's been a very vocal week between these two schools. Much love for each other. Tom Zamorski will talk this over.
After the play, personal foul. 91 of the defense.
Tydrick Powell. Let's take a look at our peak performer of the game, and it's Terrell Manning. What a day he's had. 11 tackles, one sack, and three passes broken up. And two of those passes, Arch, have come on key third down passes.
Yeah, none bigger than the last one. North Carolina was moving the football, and he came in and batted the football away and really created he really has been a problem all day long for North Carolina.
First and 10 for State at the North Carolina 14-yard line.
So North Carolina team has scored 49 points a week ago against a really good Wake Forest team, a team you and I have seen a number of times this year. That was an impressive win. It's just been completely stonewalled by NC State's defense.
Getting a heavy dose of James Washington here. 3 more yards for Washington on his first 100-yard day. He had 526 yards a year ago, this year coming into this game. And he's picking up the pieces to a running game that has really had some fits and starts because of injury. Mustafa Green was the guy that they were really looking for as their number one back. He had a leg injury and he's missed the season. Now Washington picking up the fuel, and the better he gets, the better Mike Glennon gets.
Well, this really bodes well for them from a confidence standpoint in a running game as they move forward here, as you mentioned, Steve, as you make that drive towards a bowl game possibility. The better you can run it makes you two-dimensional. They really had not been two-dimensional until today. They did an excellent job of running the football.
North Carolina not really making an effort to call timeout here. Should be the second shutout in this series since 1921. The first shutout of this in this town, not necessarily in this field. And the last shutout was in 1960 over at Chapel Hill. It was a 3-0 score. Today looking at 14-0 and the clock rolling down. As Tom O'Brien and his staff look at a very positive outcome for this one as they will get above the 500 mark in about 17 seconds. Last play from scrimmage in the game. Moving the pile is Washington, and he'll come to a rest at the 8-yard line. And the clock will just count down. Tom O'Brien comes out onto the field. And it's just like anything else. It's North Carolina losing to NC State. The Wolfpack take their fifth straight win in this series. For Dave Archer and Scott Przybylski, this is Steve Martin reminding you, you've been watching coverage of Atlantic Coast Conference football on the ACC Network, an exclusive production of Raycom Sports. The celebration is on Saturday in Raleigh as for the fifth straight year, NC State defeats North Carolina 13-0. And for the first time in 51 years, it's a shutout, a defensive effort that really was unparalleled for NC State this afternoon.
Yeah, unbelievable job defensively. Mike Archer's defense was phenomenal, and they got a good, solid running game from James Washington, over 100 yards for him today, and that was enough.
And, of course, Washington got him going. As we look at the highlights, he pushed the ball deep, and then it was up to Mike Glennon to find the receivers, and he found T.J. Graham.
Yeah, T.J. Graham makes a great catch in the back of the end zone. But as you said, Steve, the running game really set up that play-action game.
And, of course, the defense took over from that point. A couple of safety field goals, but the defense was up to the task with 3 interceptions.
Yeah, the unbelievable job by a defense that really struggled a week ago against Florida State. They lost 34-0 in Tallahassee, but today they were dialed in. Amerson has the interception. And then Giovanni Bernard, who came in the leading freshman rusher in the country. He does get over 1,000 today, but just 46 yards rushing on the day and really limited.
A limited day for him and for the Tar Heels as the Wolfpack win again. And standing by on the field, our Scott Przybylski talked with Tom O'Brien.
Coach, your defense, what can you say about how well they played here today?
I mean, it's unbelievable to get a shutout, especially in a rival game like this one. You know, great effort on both sides of the ball. Great job by the coaching staff. Great job by the players.
Did you sense how much your club was dialed in for this game as the week went on?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you know, this is a big game for this school, for our fans and our alumni. And, you know, it's great to come out, and especially here at home after the way we played last week.
Hey, go enjoy it.
Thank you. Definitely will.
Okay, that's a very happy Tom O'Brien as his club gets the shutout here today over North Carolina.
Happy because his team is now above the 500 mark at 5-4 with a 13-0 win over the North Carolina Tar Heels.